All right.
They got a bunch of four-wheelers pull over and stuff.
Jesus, what is Colin doing here?
Colin just pokes his head in to say he's at Caroline's this weekend.
What is he doing awake?
All right, John. So John wants to tell us that there's a lot of cops on the turnpike. We're going to be safe today.
Oh, boy.
Colin.
How you doing, baby?
Colin, get over here because you got to hear this guy.
I like
That's
this guy.
Andrew.
All right. This is Andrew, our new character.
Oh, this guy?
Yeah, we just found him today. Man, but
I was downstairs hanging out for 20 minutes.
Here you are? With the bikers?
Yeah.
He's going to be a big star, this guy, Andrew.
He drives a private, I guess, cab service in the Bronx.
Yes. I understand that Berkowitz took the hit for a couple of your boys, too.
Which is a very dangerous job for you.
For the passengers.
And now that we have a big star in the studio, it's really going to freak out Andrew. What do you think, Andrew?
Why don't you stalk me and kill me to put me out of my misery?
Well, that would be too easy.
Kill me.
Big fan of Colin?
Yeah, I like him. Very funny.
Yeah, you watch... Did you watch Tough Crowd?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, you watched Tough Crowd. Yes.
I'll give you, and I'm not kidding right now, I swear to you, I'll give you $10,000 over the course of a couple of incremental payments if you kill Norton. Doesn't have to be you on the air. Just in your own time. If Norton turns up strangled and I'm going to send you $10,000. And if it's Voss, $8,000. And bring me Voss's teeth as proof that you killed him. Oh. I left on my altar. I was murdered on the altar. I'm a martyr.
Should we bring this guy to Philly? Is there anyone out there that could get him to Phily?
Everybody's listening to him out there. They love him already.
Yeah.
Really?
I don't know. He
could be the official spokesperson for this damn thing.
You up for going to Philly?
Yeah. Andrew somehow you have a cell phone where you could call in the show?
Yeah, I have a cell phone.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you don't remove the mic from that guy.
Ever.
Don't get too close to him. You ever see something about Mary? He grabs the... Hey. By the way, one of the bikers down there has a little half ostrich shell cup for Norton to ride along in as a hatchling.
As a hatchling. That's great.
It's got to be a half. You can't put him in the whole one because he's already lost his egg tooth that he chips out of the egg.
He's like this the whole trip.
He would just
my...
be stranded. At the truck stops, you could regurgitate food into his mouth to feed him.
All right, we're going to have to get Andrew to go to Philly because we need to talk to you all day.
You have a cell phone, though, right?
Yes, I have a cell phone. Yes.
You must have a plan with a lot of minutes because I think any conversation probably takes you a long time.
What you got to do is remember one thing for the rest of your life.
Yes.
The scratches on my hands are from my cat, officer.
Hey, is Pat from Menaki downstairs? Yeah. Could Andrew ride with Pat? That would be a great team.
Oh my God, imagine that.
And then we'll have Pat and Andrew check in from the ride, and then we'll have Keith the cop checking in. It's going to be a great day. It's the WoW motorcycle
Better
ride.
Have some pallets of cinder blocks in the back of the van so it doesn't just flip over forward with these two in there. Kind of hefty, aren't you? What do you eat poorly or?
Oh, actually, I'm on a diet to lose weight right now. Actually,
you are.
Yes, I am.
How's that working out for you?
Not bad.
Not bad. Right. How long you been on it?
About 3 weeks.
3 weeks, and you lost any weight?
Over 10 pounds.
Over 10 pounds.
Not bad.
Congratulations.
Do you have a gal?
No, I don't.
No. No. Besides, you know. Under a pile of lime in your basement.
Not enough trunk space. You grew up in the Bronx? You grew up in the Bronx, didn't you?
Yes.
I knew it.
Yes.
Really? That must have been a tough upbringing, huh? You get beat up by the black people? No? Yeah,
you grew up in the Italian part.
Oh, yeah? The Italian part?
Is that where you were?
Oh, close.
Wow. Yeah. Wow, we have a lot of calls coming in. Let's go to John in Ohio. John?
Yeah.
Hey. Go ahead, John.
Speak.
You're on the radio. Let's go.
Hey, how you guys doing? Hey, they got to take Andrew down to Philly with him so he can hold the bikes up when they get to use his retard strength to change the tires.
Obviously, the guy is of sound mind.
Obviously.
Just has a speech impact. People sometimes think maybe you're mentally incapacitated a little bit because of your speech impediment.
Sometimes.
Sometimes,
yes.
Yeah.
If that guy from Ohio could have seen Andrew's eyes when he said retard strength.
Oh, really?
He would have took it back even in Ohio.
Yeah.
His eyes just went like, All right.
Yeah.
Daddy beat me senseless, and that's why I'm shy, but I swear to God, don't nobody touches me again.
I will kill this guy.
I'm going to kill him.
All right, we should get some more of these people in here before
bring a couple of the girls in, then.
Keep Andrew right where he is.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Danny, I bow to
you. I
want
to see which ones Eric picks.
By the way, Anthony, we got to acknowledge Danny today. Danny found Andrew.
Danny.
Danny took it upon himself to go down there and record some of these people.
He's a star, is right. You can tell, though.
See, Colin, this is what it's all about, right?
Holy God. Mary. Well,
this
Corinne
is
called
what
me up
it's
and told
all
me
about.
That this was going to happen.
Oh, my God. Hey, ladies.
Hi.
This is Andrew.
Hi. Hello.
Andrew, say it. What do you think, Andrew?
Very nice.
I would have said it the same way, so don't feel strange.
Yeah. Imagine what you could do with them with a bow saw and some duct tape, right?
Girls, be careful dress like that. Your breasts might come out on the drive down. Be careful.
You could get a violation.
You know what I'm saying?
Wow, these are lovely young ladies, aren't they? And you're all dancers? Do you dance at all? No,
no, it's like a bikini bar,
it's
right?
A bikini bar. You just kind of strut around in your bikinis and.
Is it an all ages bar? They look 14.
Now, how old are you,
is there
ladies?
Anything wrong with that?
How old are you all?
21, 18, 22,
and 39.
That's great.
I heard 39. Who was 39?
Who said that?
Very nice. And you guys are gonna go to Philly with us today?
Yeah.
Awesome. Yep. We're gonna have a good time. There's gonna be a big party going on.
They're wearing something in your honor.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You guys want to show them your special, ooh, special panties?
Oh, my God. They got,
look at that. They
got show what says on the back.
They got open
wow on the back.
With wow on the back. Are we handing out the panties today?
It's just a bevy of very nice asses.
I'm not complaining.
Just turned around.
What a great promotional item for the show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Someone's going to wow Andrew.
Huh?
Someone has to wow Andrew.
Yeah.
Andrew, it's Whip Mouth Wednesday. Someone's got to wow Andrew.
Is there any girls that are willing to wow Andrew?
You will. Corinne doesn't
play
games.
Wait, Corinne will do it. Donkey Sauce. Hold on. Well, you got to get him on mic, though. That's the whole gag. What do you think there, Andrew?
Yeah, I got to shut the curtain.
Very nice.
Oh, Jesus.
Beautiful.
Wow. You are about the creepiest son of a bitch I've ever come across.
That right hand is twitching.
Oh, I know. Yeah. How long does it take to choke one of these bitches out? You gotta know down to the second.
You ever seen a stepfather?
Yeah.
Sounds like you had a strict upbringing. Are we here to talk about me or buy a house?
Hey, you girls are friendly, holding hands. That's cute. That's very
There's
cute.
There's a bunch of them holding hands.
You're just kind of supporting each other. Is that it?
Yeah, she's my girlfriend.
She's your girlfriend? You don't have to say, no, you're just kidding. Just leave it at that. Just let that one lie there.
Well, girls love to do the fake lesbian stuff now.
Yeah.
They kind of make believe a little bit, right?
Yeah, it's a little forced, but sometimes it probably leads to real stuff.
Okay.
I bet lesbians love it.
Yeah.
Real ones, because they're like, oh.
What celebrity does everyone tell you look like? You.
Me?
Yeah.
I got Jennifer Love Hewitt.
I see it.
There it is. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
What about Eva Longoria from that other show, The Walking Desperate?
Wow, very, very nice. And look, Andrew's, he's just chomping at the bit.
Andrew, are you sporting?
Not yet, but almost.
I gotta ask you, you mind a couple of, not ridiculous personal questions, but maybe a little personal question. When was the last time you hooked up? And by that I don't mean a block and tackle and a hook in your basement. I mean, like, got a woman. Had the pleasure of a woman.
About a year ago.
A year ago?
Yeah.
Did you pay for it?
No.
No? But she did.
Sleeping under a pile of leaves somewhere. She was at 3 in the morning. She was leaving some club in Yonkers. I said, "East Chester Avenue, where are we going?"
Her new address, Shallow Grave, right?
Yeah. Co-op City.
Yeah, like a year ago?
Give us the details.
How did that happen? Was it a bar? Was it a fair?
Actually, it was a customer, actually.
A customer?
Well, I like this story already.
Picked her up in the cab. You start, chit-chatting a little bit?
Late night?
Actually, I had you guys on, actually.
Oh, really?
It was just talking and chatting.
Yeah. Yeah. You're talking.
She asked me what time I got off.
Uh-huh.
And I hooked up with her after I got off.
Oh.
I went to her house.
That's nice. Went to her place.
Yeah.
And what, maybe a little drink? You partake in a little of the drink?
Yeah, occasionally, yes.
A little bit?
Yes.
And no. Then, and what did this girl look like?
Yick.
Yick? All right.
That's gratitude.
Yeah.
Yick.
Yick. Well, you won't find any yicks today on the way down to Philly, that's for sure. If you could take that as a compliment, girls. What an awful compliment. No yicks here.
Maybe we should set Andrew up with Stalker Patty.
Well, you ever met Patty?
Actually, I've taken some pictures of her.
Yeah?
And talking with her.
Yeah.
Before.
Patty, have you met Andrew?
Yeah, outside on the street, coming over.
Yeah, coming over. What do you think of him?
They're all very nice.
They're all the very nice?
Yeah, he's very nice. All
his,
the guys
all
are
his
very
personality.
Nice. Everybody's nice.
Would you maybe, if, you know, and we'd be willing to foot the bill here, would you go out on a date with Andrew? I think both of you could use maybe a little company.
Of course I would.
All right, maybe we could set that up.
Sure, I'd go
a little
out
a night out on the town here in Manhattan. You go to dinner, maybe a little dancing. Or something. You dance at all, Patty?
Just by myself at home when I'm exercising. I do my aerobics.
Oh, Christ. You don't.
These two are
what songs
perfect
you listen to?
For each
what
other.
Music you listen
Let's
to?
Get physical. Physical.
A lot of dance tunes from the 60s, mostly by sure. The Four Seasons yeah. Or Supremes or something
yeah.
Like
Strawberry
that.
Strawberry Alarm Clock.
And then some of the disco things, you know,
yeah,
like Electric
yeah.
Slide.
Yeah. She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. And she's dancing like she never danced before.
With her leg warmers.
I feel a lot better than that when I sing.
Oh, she could use, like, those wrist warmers for leg warmers. What are they called? I stink.
trying to reenact that scene from Flashdance with the water.
Oh,
no.
She lays back in the chair, pulls a little rope, and a bucket full of water hits her. Should be blood, and she should be in a prom dress on a stage.
Patty, I stopped by your work yesterday. You know.
I know you did.
Godiva.
I was off.
I know. I stopped by your diva to see
Colin
Patty.
Got some chocolate.
No, I stopped by to see Patty.
Oh, you really
yeah.
did?
Yeah.
What a good guy.
I learned a couple people have been by, you know, when I've been there. Opie yeah. came. You come a lot of times.
Oh.
He's not Andrew,
me and you may have
well,
to
not a lot
out.
Of times, but you come every once in a while.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I only saw Opie there once.
And that's the only time you'll see me there. It was a major coincidence. Brad in Dallas, what's up?
Yeah, I was wanting to know if this cat Andrew would mind saying, some people call it a Kaiser blade, I call it a string. You guys have a good day, man.
All right.
And Andrew, would you mind going out with Patty maybe for a night out?
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I would.
Yeah.
Be honest, though. Is she your type? We like honesty on the show. What do you think of Patty?
You know, with the awful pulse and breathing. You're tight? Somehow I don't think this is his impediment coming in. I think he's just not speaking.
Well, you have a relevant comparison to make with the rest
wow.
of the room.
Well, that is true.
Yeah, it's a tough morning for her to be.
Out of these girls right here, there's such a variety of beauty in the studio. Which is the most your type? Don't be shy. Just point one out that is the most your type of girl. Yeah, blondes, brunettes, tall.
They're all looking away.
Petite.
They're all yeah. looking away. Usually you do that, and the girls will look at the guy,
yeah,
wanting,
yeah.
hoping.
I don't know.
In this case, they're all turning around looking at the wall.
Andrew, you have to know right away. It's a thing guys know. They can look at a group of girls, and
you know
which type, which one you find your type.
He's just trying to
which one, Andrew?
Himself with the rest of them.
Which one?
Over there.
What's your name, Missy? Come on, victim number one, step up to the mic.
You're the lucky one he chose.
What's your name?
Christina.
Christina.
Yes.
And how tall a gal are you?
5'8" and a half.
You're 5'8" and a half, blonde hair, very attractive girl.
Thank you.
Very beautiful. And you are Andrew's type.
Great.
Would you object? To Would you object to being in a well with a poodle?
It puts the fucking lotion in.
Oh, you mean that blonde girl, Christina? Yes, I know who she was. She used to live here.
Well, what do you think of Andrew?
He's a nice guy.
A nice guy, right?
Yeah.
Seemed nice enough, kind of a loner. Never really talked to the neighbors much.
And then the horrific find.
Occasionally brought out lumpy shopping bags.
Yeah, you just, I fast forward maybe a few months down the road, just seeing cops pulling out boxes and boxes out of his apartment with tape over them. That yellow tape. Do not fuck with this box tape.
Bunch of weird female driver's licenses in a box.
Some jewelry. They call those trophies. Yeah, so he found you, Well, would you ever go out with a guy like Andrew? Just based on, I know he's a nice guy, and if you sat down and talked to him, you'd probably shoot yourself. But if you got to know him a little bit, maybe things would be different. But just on first impression, would you go out with a?
Probably not.
Probably not?
No.
What's your type?
Not him.
This is brutal.
No offense. Sorry.
Andrew, you have to know that whatever, you know, you're dealt a hand in life, and you got to play it, and obviously...
Andrew, basically, Ant's trying to tell you got to aim a lot lower.
Yeah, you got to aim lower.
If he really kept working out and going to keep on a diet, and then you shaved your head and grew, like, the goatee, maybe some earrings, a little ink...
Yeah, you might be able to hook yourself up a little
better.
Might be able
to, you know, work it.
All right, we got to get everyone out of here, because people are getting nervous.
Oh, really?
Hey, what's especially up? That guy that we're not allowed to talk about.
How you doing, man?
Hey, Keith the Cop, come on up to the mic and tell us what's going to happen here, all right? Give us the whole deal again in case we got new listeners tuning in here.
Absolutely. We're going to be leaving the studio. We're going to be heading down the New Jersey Turnpike, or Garden State Turnpike, whatever.
New Jersey Turnpike.
Jersey Turnpike. It's that turnpike.
Yeah, that one that runs New Jersey.
In Jersey.
Yeah,
what's it called?
Jersey. Yeah, the New Jersey Turnpike heading down to Club Risque, which is located at 1700 South Columbus Boulevard in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
So like I said, make sure you got your wow on your car, etching in the paint, do what you got to do. We got a lot of lovely ladies here. Just want to thank two people.
Sports Sexy. Come on.
Sports Sexy.
Yeah.
Thank them for coming down.
Girls rock.
Also, we have a large group of riders from Nick David. Nick David brought down a whole bunch of his guys. Tri-State.
Wait. Get a plug in, bro.
Appreciate it. Ooh. How you guys doing?
Hey,
what's up,
mister?
Yeah, my name is Nick David, and I represent TriStateSportBikes.com. It's an online community for the entire tri-state area. It's about 2,500 motorcycle riders on there right now.
Nice.
Looking to get into the tens of thousands, hopefully with you guys' help. Appreciate it.
Awesome. Sure. Check it out.
So we're going to have some fun today and see some titties or something.
Hell yeah.
Of course we are.
Fucking A.
That's what this is all about. Whip them out Wednesday.
Fuck yeah.
All the way down to Philly. All right. Good. All right.
Good job.
A lot, guys.
And you guys ready to leave? Is that
what
we're getting at?
Just real quick, Mike from Sports Sexy.
Oh, Mike.
Brought the lovely ladies down today.
Mike.
How you doing?
He's the man.
Just want to thank you guys on behalf of the Sports Sexy Cafe, located Route 46 in Totowa, New Jersey. We brought the girls.
Where do you find these hot women to work for your place?
I hired every one of them.
Did you?
How many have you had sex with?
Oh, Jesus.
Probably the wrong time to ask that question.
Don't be. My goodness.
Thank you, guys.
Don't have any girls in the room just said he better say one.
You know that hand in life I was talking about? Four aces right there, that guy.
All right.
That guy's been dealt the aces. You got, like, I don't know, seven deuce offsuit.
All right, Ben's freaking out. We got to get everyone out.
Oh, by the building? We're out of here. We'll see you on the road.
All right, Keith, call us from downstairs before you take off.
Absolutely.
We're going to take a quick break.
If the building is yelling at you, Ben, pull out your hog and wrap it against the side and knock it down.
Pat from Menaki, what's up?
Oh, hey, what's up,
Pat? Hey, how you doing, Pat? We found someone. We found someone that you got to bring down to Philly.
Block 614, yeah, the era of Pat from Munaki is officially over.
Oh, you think
the
so?
New era, oh, yeah.
You think this guy's going to steal all your thunder?
I think so. Just don't take my Patty. She's mine. I will battle you for her.
And this guy has 10 toes. Count them.
That's right.
show off.
In his dresser with other legs and appendages.
He even has a murderer's haircut.
Of course he does.
Fuck.
All right, pal, we got to let you go.
People are telling you, you gotta let me go?
Yeah, but Andrew's joining you on the ride, and we want you guys to check in a lot today, all right?
Okay, hey, this is officially 64 bikes, and there's more pulling up as I speak.
Yeah. Very good.
Put Andrew on a 5-second delay so he doesn't curse.
Thank you, Pat.
All righty.
All right.
That Andrew is what we call gold.
Yes. Radio
it
gold.
It is what we call gold.
He really is.
You rarely come across somebody that is like that on the air.
Radio Gold. The first time we ran into Stalker Patty,
right.
From Menaki,
it's
Wheelchair
just,
Fred. It only happens every once in a while.
When you're a radio prospector with your pan on the side of the river, and you're just looking at nothing for so long, and then all of a sudden something just glimmers in the sunlight, and a big chunk of gold is there. That is Andrew.
Stalker Patty even knew it.
Yeah.
She saw it in the back of the room. She got all bummed out.
I thought he was so good, I thought he was faking. I'm like, this
I know,
can't
it
be real.
Can't be real.
Let me ask you, in the context of that, finding, like, gold freak show people.
Yeah.
On the one hand, you guys like these talented comics. On the other hand, you look for these freak psychos.
Can you get to it faster, stupid?
Where would Norton fall into that category?
So he seems to straddle both worlds rather well.
God, it took a while to get
How's that stupid? Worth getting to.
As soon as your mouth opened,
it was worth it.
You knew it was going to be a bash on you.
I'm like, look, the door's open. Just walk through, shithead.
Kevin from Connecticut. What's up, Kevin?
Guys, you got to describe Andrew for me physically.
Wow, he's a
bit... Let me tell you what I think, first of all, as a listener, okay? You know the Franks and Beans guy from Something About Mary? I think he looks like him.
Not too far off,
I'll tell you who he looks exactly like.
He's got a little bit of Melvin from Office Space.
Definitely the Melvin from Office Space in there.
A little bit of the Adam Sandler's excited Southerner guy.
A little bit.
Yeah, you put all those together.
But he's like leather. He's like built and big as Leatherface.
Leatherface. Yeah, that's...
He looks like an unpleasant-looking Leatherface.
Take a picture of that leather
smock. Yeah, he's a big boy. He's a big boy.
Hacking people apart.
You ever see Hollywood Nights?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He looks like the guy at the end that goes, Mother, I'm going to screw someone.
Dudley.
Yes, he looks exactly like Dudley from Hollywood Nights.
In a Steve Nights. C voice?
Yeah, that's exactly what Dudley sounded like.
Good find, Opie.
All right, let's...
Fantastic.
We're going to take a break. Thanks, Kevin.
Yes.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll check in with Keith and the rest of the gang before
can
they
I at
take
least,
off.
Can I at least promote Caroline so I don't have to do any other
Caroline's
awful stuff?
Caroline's
come on, meet this weekend with Robinson and Bob Kelly's return engagement.
Oh, Bob Kelly's back.
His limping fatness will be all over the stage.
We got audio.
Bob Kelly.
We got audio of Bob Kelly losing it on one of the
yeah,
one
we
of
had.
The
oh, I heard about one, this.
Don't you have to have it to lose it?
I guess someone wasn't enjoying his act, and Bob Kelly lost it on this guy and just couldn't get off it.
And what did he say? Go to a library, you intelligent person.
So we're going to play that next. But Colin Quinn's going to be at Caroline's this weekend. You sticking around for a little while? Or?
Yeah, a little while.
All right, cool. Let's get out of here for a little bit.
Like sends.
Calling all freaks.
That's hilarious.
Colin Quinn in studio today, playing Caroline's all this weekend. He's going to be in the New York area. Definitely check out Colin Quinn, Keith Robinson, and Fat Bob Kelly. Bob Kelly doing comedy with one leg, basically.
Oh, yeah.
And we got some classic audio Bob Kelly we're going to get to in a few minutes here.
Yeah.
But first, Anthony, it's the WOW motorcycle ride. There's so much going on. You want to explain really fast what's going to happen here?
We got a... Jesus, upwards of 70 motorcycles outside, and riders, obviously. Right. And they're going to be going down to Philly.
Right.
They're going to be going down to Philly on this wild ride. On the WOW ride that Keep the Cop helped put together.
Yeah. That cologne you're wearing is something a little child would give you. You know why you caught me? Well,
I'm going to do that all day.
Oh, God, I can't stop doing it.
All day. But it's Whip 'em Out Wednesday. You get WOW on your vehicle, and then there's ladies all over America that will see that as a sign that you want to see boobs. It's simple as that. And we're going to be wowing all the way from New York to Philly today.
Oh, so, but brilliant in its simplicity, might I add.
Exactly.
Some hotties
and
on there today.
If you listen closely, you can hear they're starting the engines up and ready to take off.
Let's say hi to Nathaniel. Nathaniel.
Yes, what's up?
What's up?
Hi, I'm trying to get this organized chaos. Would you like to speak to Andrew? I'm sticking right by him.
Yeah, Andrew's going to join Pat from Menaki for the ride down to Philly.
We'll be getting reports from him throughout the show.
Yes.
Hello?
Hey, pretty loud down there, Andrew.
Yes, it's very loud down there. I'm down here.
Down there.
Yeah, are you psyched about riding down there with Pat from Menaki?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Yeah, very much.
Have you ever met Pat, or is this the first time you're meeting Pat from Menaki? He can't hear me anymore.
Do you hear that sound? That sound is actually... That sound is the inside of Andrew's head when he watches Lizzie McGuire.
Hey, Keith! We'll see if Keith can hear us. Keith the cop. Keith!
No, that's it.
It's just way too loud out there. All right, the bikes are starting up, obviously, and they're starting their journey to Philly. Ending at Club Risque in Philadelphia.
And hot chicks all on their way down to Philadelphia. And, give them support. You see them on the road, stay away from them. Don't be any smart asses on the road. But, give me your support. Wow, man.
Is this Keith?
There's no way he's going to hear us now.
No one's going to hear anything. Hey, Keith.
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, go ahead, Keith.
All right, we're heading on out of here. We're hitting the road right now.
Do you have Patty on the back of your bike?
Yes, I have Patty on the back of my bike.
Oh, all those hot chicks, and he's got Patty on the back.
Lovely, lovely. Gentlemen, I'll talk to you in a little bit.
All right, well, you guys going to do the Lincoln Tunnel?
Yeah, we're doing the Lincoln Tunnel.
Because people are calling in. They're between the station and the Lincoln Tunnel, so you're going to pick up some more bikers before you hit the tunnel.
Outstanding. Looking forward to it.
All right, check in a little while, Keith.
Stop.
All right.
See ya.
All right, there you go. Keith the cop, everyone. Hey, Nathaniel.
Yes.
Anything else to report?
No.
No.
It's pretty crazy out there. We're getting a lot of video and pictures taken for our websites, and we'll have that up later tonight. All right, Nathaniel. Yep.
It's the majesty of a lot of people revving their engines.
I hear you. All right.
The majesty.
All right, very good. Let's go to Pete downstairs. Pete?
Yeah, I can barely hear you guys.
All right.
I'm in front of the Salisbury Hotel. There's a tour group here called Christian Tours. Everybody's got Jesus things on and crosses and everything else. Many motorcycles ripping up. They look horrified. We're scaring the shit out of them.
Yeah, the Christian Tour buses park right up on 57th here. And huge gaggles of these Christians from out of town get off the bus, and they are petrified of all the motorcycles. As well they should be. Scantily clad girls on the back. It's like everything they're against. Everything cool, fun, and sexy.
Alright, sounds like they're starting to take off, so the WOW motorcycle ride has begun to Philadelphia.
It's going to be quite a long little parade of these guys. A lot of bikes.
I don't know what the final count was. We were up to like 64 with more cycles showing up.
Yeah.
I think we're over 80 at least.
And then there's going to be some joining up. They'll be well over 100.
And then there's a bunch of cars, too, that are just going to take the trip down there. So we'll check in with Keith the cop and Andrew and Pat from Menaki in a little while. Very cool.
Andrew and Pat in the same van.
And
come
Gary
on.
Sinise telling him about the rabbits in the back.
Also, Rich Voss coming in today.
Oh, yeah?
And we got Scott Walterman, XM News. He's going to be reporting from the space shuttle launch.
The shuttle launch. When is that thing supposed to go
up? That ain't happening today.
3:51 is supposed to be launch.
I thought it was supposed to happen this morning.
No. 3:51 in the afternoon.
Oh, okay.
It's supposed to be launch time. But they've already had a problem. Last night, one of the little protective coverings for one of the cockpit windows fell off, plummeted about 65 feet. And smashed into some of the tiles over one of the engine cowlings in the back, and smashed some of the tiles, so they had to replace some of those. So the tiles had to be replaced before the thing even lights up. And they're worried a little bit about thunderstorms, too. That might delay the launch.
A couple tiles fall off. What's going to happen?
A couple of tiles. I don't think those things are very important.
And I don't think it's important that they had prepared for thunderstorms either, since they're going into another planet.
I think they're talking about our planet here at launch time.
Thank God it's not, you know, it can handle itself in like against Martian invaders, but a little rain.
That is a little odd. The thing's up there with, you know, no atmosphere and everything. Yet, you know, a little rain. You could take your goddamn car out in the rain.
I wish Voss was here right now, because the minute we started talking about anything scientific, his face would have shown this fear like this. He's like, you're kidding, school. I hope they don't pick on me.
I know nothing about
this.
I'll
keep this side.
Jim, what?
I'll keep this side. When we get up to 9th Avenue, I'll let you cut in and go in front.
What's going on, Jim?
This way we keep the street blocked.
Jim, what's up?
Yo, sorry, guys. I'm talking to somebody else that's in another vehicle.
All right,
Left count was 72. We're up to, what are we up to, Broadway here. It looks gorgeous, I got to tell you. It is a blast, guys. It's hard to hear you even from back there in the car.
Very cool. Yeah, a bunch of cars are following the bikes as well. And
we got, well, unfortunately, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania says I can't ride right now, so. We got a nice crowd going here. We're going to have a good time going down.
All right, cool, Jim. Keep us updated on the progress, okay?
Yeah, you want me to leave my cell phone with you?
No, just keep calling in.
All right, later, bye.
We'll look for you. Thanks, Jim.
Later, guys.
All right, he counts 72 bikes so far. Yeah, but the space shuttle, you think after 2 years, pieces wouldn't be falling off it before
Yeah,
launch.
You would think whoever put that little protective thing on the window, yeah, his head should roll, I think. It's one of those, you know, everyone's watching kind of moments, and make sure you batten that thing down.
Amazing.
I don't think it'll launch, though, either. I think it's going to be one of those,
There's no way it launches.
Five, four, three. Oh, we have a delay, and then they delay, they pull the astronauts out of there, and you got to wait for another day.
All right, every time.
Not like in the movies.
Well, we'll talk to Scott Walterman a little later today.
And who is he?
He's a very serious newsman.
Is he a real news guy for XM?
For XM, yes.
What does he usually do when the shuttle isn't launching?
Because
I don't think, is there an XM news channel?
Yeah, I think.
Is there?
I don't know. We do our thing and he does his thing.
I'd like to know if there's some kind of what he does.
I think he does a little news here and there.
You think he gathers news for maybe Bob Edwards?
I think he does news for Deep Tracks.
Deep Tracks news? Yeah. What's Pink Floyd up to today?
I don't know what he does. I don't know what half these people do down there in Washington. But we'll check in with him. Also, Chris Angel in studio today at 10 a.m., Ben?
Yes.
He's that magician. That
I've seen his billboard up outside the Midtown Tunnel.
Ben, he wrote a note that says, Voss lost. What does that mean?
I don't know. He's lost.
Where is he lost?
How can he be lost? He's been here.
Oh boy.
He bombs on a napkin.
What did you think was going to happen? I was going to look at this and go, Voss lost.
Jim, since you're booking guests now and not telling anyone. You know.
I didn't book a guest. You
look how he just changed the subject of how his little note to Jimmy just tanked.
I know, but Jim, yeah. Jim told me to come in tomorrow.
Well, he's in the Daily News, and he mentioned this in the Daily News. He's
Jim's producing the show now, secretly.
Well, someone should. He's part of the Tsunami song, and he was fired. And he called me. He wanted to come in now that he's going to talk again. So I'm like, yeah, email ben.sparks@xmradio.com. And I'm not telling anybody out there to send pictures of cocks or anything to ben.sparks@xmradio.com, because that's distracting and it annoys Ben.
That would not be professional.
Don't send him things that sound good and then write shit dick in big letters, because that would make his job difficult. Todd apparently did not email Ben, but he's coming in tomorrow.
Well, that's cool.
Yes.
Good to have Todd in here.
Yeah, it doesn't change the fact that you invited him.
Oh, my God. Yeah. No. Sorry, I don't mean to change the subject.
Oh, we saw that picture being taken.
All right, look at this. Oh, what did I do?
Nothing, sweetie. It just happens.
Who is it, Andrew?
Yeah, he's got a picture of Andrew. Look. We saw them taking that picture, and we were laughing at his expression.
You can now see our latest creation, Andrew, on opiateanthony.com. There's a picture of him right there. Oh, for your viewing pleasure.
Look at that.
I've never seen a human being look more uncomfortable in my life.
No.
He is Mike Buschetti if you were a model.
He is uncomfortable in his own skin. Look at him.
Absolutely not a hint of a muscle on that body.
Cheese. I'm going as far as Fontana, but then I can drop you off at the truck stop there.
I didn't see that face in the sleeper when you were 16-year-old runaway.
Oh, God. Damn. Oh, God.
You could take a nap in the back.
Just wakes up all groggy and he's over her nude.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, he opens the trunk, it's like Billy Batts. No, Tommy, no. No, Andrew. Andrew, no.
And he's not nude. He's naked, except he's wearing socks and work boots.
Just making that sound.
Voss lost. Oh. I'm going to laugh all day reading that napkin.
No, it's a joke, though.
Dugout Doug, what's up?
What's going on, guys? Hey, I wanted to put out there that I'm doing a WOW sticker stop tonight at the Virginia Beach Funny Bone for Rich Voss's show at 8 o'clock.
He's going to be in Virginia Beach tonight?
What's that?
He's going to be in Virginia tonight?
Yeah, he's in Virginia Beach, Virginia at the Funny Bone.
Tonight? How's he going to get down there?
I don't know.
Maybe he's flying.
Maybe. All right.
Why, is he up there?
He's going to be here today.
Supposed to be, but he's lost.
I actually heard he's going to be doing radio down here on FM 99 WNOR in a little bit. I was trying to keep an ear open so I can do wacky radio with him or something, but I don't know. Maybe he lied to you guys.
Something's up. All right, we'll figure it out.
God bless.
Thanks, Doug. Let's go to Rob in Philly. Rob, what's up?
Hey. I was wondering, did you talk to Colin yet about his awful appearance on Celebrity Poker and his garbage man hands?
Oh, my God. Colin will play anything.
Do we have the audio?
He actually won the first round.
I won my awful first round.
Yeah. But he played awful. You should not have won that.
I play against the grain. What, do you want to play ace-king like an idiot?
Colin, I'm with you.
No, but you were playing like seven deuce off suit.
And what happened? I hit because it's all about the flop. It doesn't matter.
You just got lucky. I know.
No, dumb people play ace-king. I win high two cards. The flop is important.
Right. But I don't know.
Yeah, maybe you should talk to me about this weekend in Vegas when I was down $2,700. At 4 in the morning, I had $40, and I played high-stakes slots, 3 diamonds, 4,000.
$4,000?
Yes.
Nice. That is a nice
hit.
Bad,
and huh? I won in Celebrity Poker, too. And the only reason I lost the second game is because I let that dumb Phil get in my head, and I didn't play a 4-6 that would have won it all, and I told him that. I saw him this weekend.
Phil Gordon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Speaking of the flop, what time's your show tonight?
It's actually tomorrow night, but thanks for promoting.
Wow.
Flop.
We got the audio of you on Celebrity Poker. We had a lot of fun with this at your expense.
Good.
Let's go to the first track here.
I feel if a fella can't take a joke, whatever.
Andrew, no, Andrew.
Don't eat the cards.
I'll call.
I can't get enough of that guy.
I drew the death card.
I feel like we could go home now.
I know. He's the best.
Dream much, Will.
No one's going to remember anything else we do today.
He's got to be the spokesman for
all about Andrew today.
Yeah, he does. From now on. Okay, and you've got to track all the girls he met today and see what their next year is like.
All right, here we go.
Colin shows a jack of diamonds.
And Trip Jacks is going to take Colin Quinn a nice pot here. Yeah. Folks, playing jack five offsuit, not a good idea. Colin's getting very lucky here.
Lucky, you idiot. I played my whole life, stupid.
Yeah, you play, what was it, jack five?
Yeah.
And the flop comes out, and there's two jacks in the flop.
Because the flop is not predicted.
But the odds of that happening are very slim. You're probably going to lose your bet.
Yeah.
Because there's going to be crap comes out, or somebody's got an ace, and an ace comes out.
I know you my whole life, from right away you're getting fresh. I'm trying to... There's an hog in the middle of it. No disrespect, Henry, are you nuts? Teach this kid a little fucking manners, Jimmy.
Let's say hi to John in Virginia. John.
Fresh.
Yeah, Opie's, he's an idiot. I mean, he's talking about odds. He's playing Caribbean Stud. It's the biggest house game in the casino.
Who's playing Caribbean Stud?
I just play... I'm an idiot when it comes to cards. I'll be the first to admit it. Yeah. I play three-card poker because you don't have to do anything.
I like the three-card poker. That's a fun game.
You just sit there and watch what happens.
You get a good hand. I don't play the Caribbean poker. I play the three-card poker. I made $6,000 in Atlantic City 2 weeks
ago. Yeah, that's like playing deuce seven off suit. You're going to do that once every 50 times.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, bullshit, Werner.
All right, John wants to call me an idiot.
Ask him why that was.
Thanks, John.
I think he meant to say I was an idiot, and he was just talking to you.
No, because I agree with you.
Well, I mean,
they're all idiots.
I like playing against the grain. I like playing against the grain. It's fun. All right,
you know just because we're not smart cards and we're idiots. Why don't you read Emotional Intelligence? Huh? Noop. Airport book.
Let's go to John in Jersey. John?
What's up, boys? I'm in a red car in the back of procession. It's probably about 10 or 15 cars following the motorcycle ride. They're getting into the Lincoln Tunnel for anybody in Jersey who wants to meet them on the other side.
Lincoln Tunnel,
the traffic's really screwed up right now. I don't know if it's like the tunnel normally or 80 maniacs on motorcycles right now.
It could be, you know, rush hour in Midtown Manhattan.
So they're right at the Lincoln Tunnel?
Yeah, I'm trying to get into the tunnel right now.
All right, very good, because there are people on the other side of the tunnel that are going to join the WOW motorcycle ride to Philly.
And keep an eye out for a used Mercedes coming the other way. Rich Voss, I'm late to his traffic.
Hey, by the way, guys, there's one guy in the truck who's got a great idea. He put a bunch of signs on his car so that it said, you know, if you want to listen to Opie and Anthony, tune into, you know, these two FM channels to, you know, read off his modulator.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Oh, yeah, so if you get close to the car, you can...
A lot of people have been doing that for us. That's very cool. All right, thank you, John.
Later, boys.
So John has joined the WOW ride. He's behind all the sickles. Another track, another cut from Colin Quinn on Celebrity Poker here. Oh.
And Colin with an 8-10.
So it's 18 to me? Is going to... Looks like he's calling this out of position. This is just horrible.
Colin calls?
No, Phil, he has an 8-10 off suit.
Yeah, okay.
You must have missed that.
Yeah, and Phil, what happened that hand?
What happened that hand, Colin?
I won.
You
good
did?
Good to be home, fellas.
You did?
Of course I did. 10. I won that game. I lost the second game only because I beat everybody out the second game. I did all the dirty work. Then Brad Garrett beat me because I bitched, because I listened to Phil get in my head that I didn't play a 4-6 same suit. That ended up with a fight. We would have been a straight flush, probably.
Cocksuckers got every 8-10 in the deck.
What do you say there, guys? I don't know. Kind of like that. Yeah, and I ain't even cheating yet.
All right. Yeah, are you saving Barnes up to be, Colin? Jewish?
Barnes' idea of being funny.
I ain't even cheating yet.
He laughed because he's a fucking got scars on his face.
What do you say there, Bob? Can I like that? Make it. That's precisely what I thought.
No reaction from Barnes at all. No. Just
Let's say hi to Craig the cop. Craig?
Yo, guys, what's going on?
What do you got today, Craig?
Hey, I want to let you guys know the Turnpike has a website set up that you can view traffic traveling live on the Pike today.
Okay.
And anybody wants to check out the bikes going down to Philly, be able to view that live.
All right. What's the site?
It's www.state.nj.us/turnpike/nj.
That's why I want him to rent the website out.
That's easy.
Right.
A handy one. That's almost like Yahoo.
Right.
So easy.
Just tell them to go to jerseyturnpike.com, and the web link them right to the cameras.
All right. Thank you, Craig.
All right, guys. Good luck, man.
All right.
And then you can sit and watch traffic. That's a wonderful website.
Helping us out, though. They're helping us out for the WOW motorcycle ride with Keith the Cop, Anthony, who has Stalker Patty on the back of his ride. Sure he does.
No, he didn't take it? You mean he dropped her off?
I don't know.
She
I
says
heard
the North Vietnamese make us take the weapons. Oh, bullshit, Warner!
I heard Patty is on the back of his motorcycle.
I hope so.
She may have had a stunning makeover from the time she was up here till the time she got out on the motorcycle.
You think she fell off the back accidentally?
I think she had a stunning makeover.
I'm sure she was on the back of his bike for the photo op.
I was brutally thrown into the street, but I had to work today anyway.
I got road rash. This is wonderful.
All right, another.
I want to join the Hells Angels. Fuck the pagans. I'm going to kick a little ass. Patty.
She turned into a motorcycle
mama. Biker bitch showing her tits. And
She already does that.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah, we turned her into a slut. We talked about that recently.
Yeah, you turned her out.
The virgin slut.
Here's another cut from Colin Quinn on Celebrity Poker.
Colin is what is known in the professional poker world as a calling station. If you can find a guy like this to play poker with you at a high level, you will murder him.
Play me then, Phil, at
a
high level, you scumbag.
He may catch a couple lucky flops early.
Oh, I'd love to
but
play him one
you
on
can't
one.
Win playing as passively
shut,
as he does.
Shut your face, stupid. I had no cards and I won.
They were just amazed at how you played.
I gotta give it to
I
you.
I won!
You did win. Yeah. You did. You did.
Yeah, but Phil's right. You kept going off suit.
That's off Phil. Suit. Who gives a damn?
Yeah, but you weren't playing like you weren't taking like a King Ace or a Jack
Queen. Oh, bullshit, Warner!
I sat down and played cards with Phil. I had a game with Phil in L.A., and he ripped me to shreds.
Beat you, you mean?
He killed me.
I'll play him one-on-one.
Destroyed.
He's got such a big mouth, I'll play him with real money one-on-one.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hey,
think
on the show, it'll be semi-promotionable. I don't know. Let's ask the producer. Do you think that would be his biggest Todd mentioned in the Daily News?
That's a very nice little mention for the Opie and Anthony program.
Shut up. They don't need this local mention. They got to invite people on every time they mention the paper. Shut your trap.
No,
on the next page, they're advertised. Dum-dum. Don't produce. You don't know what you're doing. Do stand-up. And study your acting. You've got a craft to get ready for this.
I'm going to Joanna Bexon today.
Are you really? Are you taking acting lessons or a class?
Yeah,
you who's teaching you?
Brushing up.
You should, really?
Jim's not a bad actor. The other, I know it because the other guy stinks so badly.
Really?
You ever seen Keith act? Oh.
I've seen in the sketches
you, ever
that
seen Voss?
You guys did. Yeah.
Even in those
Voss
sketches,
is the worst.
We're trying to be like ironically bad, and even then Voss's shame spiral starts, and he's like this. Oh. His own daughter's
shame spiral.
He goes into like a shit because the one thing in acting you have to like be accept yourself.
Right. You got to be confident in your work.
Even if you, it doesn't matter what you are. You have to say
right.
This is all I have. But even then he's like, oh. And he just starts getting like trying too hard. His daughter
just gets sucked down in his own like
yeah,
suckiness,
his own horrible self-esteem. Yeah, and he's like. Oh. I can't wait to... You know, Voss always hated me in comedy. That was like a big... Voss used to slam me, and to this day, every
really?
Time I call him on it, his he goes, no, I didn't. He starts laughing, but his eyes turn away. Because he used to call me... Because he was so dumb. Norton and them kind of recognized, oh, this guy's a real comic. But Voss was so dumb, he's like, I think he's like an alternative guy. He didn't realize I was actually funny.
Guy.
And to this day, he doesn't think I'm funny. They have to tell him that I'm funny. That
because
he likes,
you're... you know, it might
yeah.
take that you got to think a little bit.
Yeah,
and maybe moron. Have read a newspaper in the past month
yeah.
To understand some of what Colin's saying on stage. Very funny.
Yeah.
Very. I love the fact that you come up with new shit
on
a weekly basis, and it's hysterical. I'm kissing ass a little
that
bit.
Hicks.
But I've seen Colin many times, and he's hysterical.
Colin does impersonations, and if you close your eyes, you think it was the real people.
Oh, not easy.
But yeah. Voss, you know.
Well, Voss,
he's an uneducated doofus.
Yeah,
he's a buffoon.
Is.
Well, where is Voss?
I know. He really, you know.
He was supposed to be here about a half hour ago. And Colin Quinn's going to be at Caroline's tomorrow night, right?
Yeah.
Not
the
all
weekend.
Weekend? Oh, all weekend.
All weekend
okay,
with
good.
Bob Kelly, the one-legged Samoan, and Keith Robinson.
I'm buying a Learjet off of eBay. I'll be there in lickety-split. I'm flying in for a Rolls Royce.
And it broke down while he was driving.
While he's test driving it, after he put $1,000 down on it.
Oh.
It smelled like sauerkraut and bratwurst.
Actually, though, he does have a lot of new topical material. He said, Al-Qaeda's trying to kill me, and I'm dodging them.
All right, Ann, we're going to take a break. We'll check in with Keith
you
the
You hear
cop.
About those bombings in London? Yeah, how about those Nazis?
When we get back, we'll check in with Keith the Cop, see where he's at in his wild motorcycle ride to Philadelphia, okay?
Roy.
Also, the Bob Kelly audio. We got to get
yeah.
Bob Kelly on the
phone. Oh, I got to hear this.
You got to stick around for the Bob Kelly
audio. I'm going to.
We'll do that next,
all right? If producer Norton gets me a soda on the break. I only wanted if he...
I think Caroline's all this weekend with Keith Robinson and Bob Kelly.
Yeah.
We got Bob Kelly audio losing it. We're trying to get Bob Kelly on the phone so we can make fun of him a little bit. We have Keith the Cop. I think he's probably in the tunnel because he's not answering his phone right now.
Or there was a lot of traffic in the tunnel.
Yeah, the wild motorcycle ride has begun.
They're probably all going to die in there. That's got to be the worst place to be, is in a tunnel in stopped traffic with a whole parade of motorcycles just breathing in the carbon monoxide.
And Patty on the back.
Ugh. And yeah. behind Pat Fromanaghi and Andy.
Andrew.
Behind them. Oh, my God.
How great is Andrew? You know, for the people that are just tuning in, where's that audio that Andrew...
Don't call him Andy. His dad used to call
where's
him.
Where's the audio that Andy had? Yeah, you got to... I mean, this guy's a classic. We just discovered a new guy today.
That guy's been coming down to shows... And taking pictures of me like a mental patient.
Like?
What do you mean like? Exactly. Just in case you don't know who Andrew is, we discovered this guy today. Actually, Danny did. He went downstairs and taped some of the guys getting ready
Danny.
For the,
yeah.
the motorcycle ride.
Danny.
And listen to this.
Danny.
Our new find, Andrew.
So, you going on the ride today?
Actually, I just came down here to take some photos of everybody and to post on whackbag.com.
How come you're not going on the ride?
I didn't plan it.
Well, go down. It's not too late.
tag along.
I don't know who I could, you know, tag along or not, but I'm just hanging out.
Oh, my.
You know,
goodness.
I've been talking to this guy for the past couple of months on and off at shows.
Yeah.
He comes to all the shows in the Bronx, mm-hmm. Yonkers, and I never once put it together that he would be great on the air.
Yeah, see?
I never once put it together.
Joe tours with bands, and I'm sitting here.
That's right.
That's why.
Everyone knows their place.
That's
radio gold.
Beacon. You know, a beacon was coming off his head when I first saw him.
You know what happened to me when I first heard that he was going to be on? I was like, oh, no. You see, I feel too bad for a guy like that. You guys just know how to run with it. Exactly. You guys know how to run with that shit, I don't.
That is great.
All right, so what happened to him? I want to know.
Yeah, oh, there's something in the Wayback Machine.
It was that Wanderer's dad, I'm telling you.
Dad from the Wanderers.
So here's the deal. Brother Joe's in
Ducky
the studio
boy.
Today, and Joe does the tribute band thing.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And he does it very, very well.
Yeah,
I was
sure.
in the middle of, like, Pennsylvania driving home. And you were doing some huge, like, town celebration or something for a radio station?
We've been doing a lot of those,
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. They're firing them up like crazy.
All of a sudden, it's Brother Joe and the YouTube band they're talking about like crazy. Like,
yeah.
The whole town came out to see it or something.
And now you're international?
Yeah.
Listen to some of the gigs he's got going.
We're doing Puerto Rico in September. We're going to Mexico City twice in October. Yeah. Seattle, Washington for New Year's Eve. They just put us
all over the place.
A whole bunch of
Dublin.
Dublin, Ireland. We're going to be the first U2 tribute ever to play Dublin, Ireland. It'll be
you
sick.
Better be good. They'll fucking kill you.
Nah.
And what's the website again?
Drunk. NotU2.com.
NotU2.com. Okay.
Nah.
Real fast, we got to go to John in Jersey. He's part of the WoW motorcycle ride. He's in a car, I guess. John.
Hey, what's up, boys? Okay. Hey. I just want to give you an update there. That's the title. The cars are actually pretty far behind the motorcycles, but from what it looks like the motorcycles probably get onto the turnpike about 5 minutes or so.
They'll be on the turnpike in less than 5 minutes?
Probably. I mean, there's heavy traffic at 495 again, but...
So you guys have pretty much made it out of the tunnel.
Yeah, everybody's out of the tunnel. I'm the last car, I believe. Everybody's out of the tunnel.
Okay.
By the way, that psychopath Andrew, I don't think Pat's coming back from this trip alive.
Yeah, we want Pat from Menaki to give us a call, Pat. Come on. All right, thank you, John.
Later, boys.
All right, so they pretty much have left the tunnel, and they're very close to the New Jersey Turnpike as they head down to Philly to Club Risque. So, yeah, Joe's traveling all over the place with the tribute band thing.
I actually had to book a charter plane, a couple of them coming back from Rock Island and Nantucket, hopping on these little six-seater Cherokees.
With the whole band?
Yeah.
What did you do with the equipment?
Little bit, just take pieces. You have, just guitars and effects. We basically
supply
some backline.
Do acoustic versions of Peggy Sue while you're on
there. Yeah, of course, yeah. The obligatory La Bamba chorus.
What are you, crazy?
Yeah.
Taking a little plane from what, Block Island?
Block Island back to Montauk. We had to make a show. There
playing
no
on Plum Island.
Yeah. Landing, emergency landing on Plum Island.
Did you ever think it was going to get this big, Joe? You were kind of doing this as a side thing, like this is fun, and I'll go with this for a little while, and now it's blowing up.
It's playing guitar for a living, man. If you want to do it for a living, you figure out a way to do it. It's the only way to make money. You know?
Well, we're gonna eventually have like a tribute band, you know, contest.
Yeah, it's gonna be like we'll get a bunch of tribute bands, get them together, and have a little exhibition.
We're encouraging the tribute bands to send their stuff into us here in New York City.
Mm-hmm.
The address is up on opieandanthony.com. Yeah. But But Joe brought in some examples of some tribute bands.
Yeah. These are a couple that I know and some that I just went up online and checked out. Some of them are really good. Some of them are really bad. And those are generally the only two you really want to listen to, you know?
The Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young one that he just played during commercial break. Unbelievable.
Yeah, what's the deal with this band?
Yeah, it's Four Wheels, they're called, I believe. Yeah, the name is Four Way Street. They're from California, and probably the best tribute band I've ever heard.
Yeah.
This is just by this recording.
Well, they got to be in the contest then.
They're so realistic, one of them fucked Melissa Etheridge.
Colin Quinn at Caroline's all weekend long.
Hey.
Don't you get it, man? Nobody can kill Andrew but Andrew.
Now, what I love about Colin, he gets obsessed with our characters like we do.
I know. Oh,
he can't get enough of Scorch and the retarded Patty. Shirley and Stalker Patty and the rest of them. You just love it, right?
I've been to visit Patty like 7 times.
Yeah. He goes down there and visits her down at Godiva.
The staff's like, oh, she's not here. Okay, tell her I said hi.
Did you ever meet Pat from Munaki?
No.
Oh, see, you would love Pat.
Yeah, I didn't get
to talk to him. He's got a complete lack of any type of self-confidence. He comes in here and tries to tell jokes and has no confidence in him. So
why doesn't
he
write them on a napkin like Ben?
Like Ben and slide them to...
Lost.
Yeah. He was originally known for swilling down 2 gallons of eggnog, was it?
Yeah, that was his
ridiculous
first...
ridiculous amount of eggnog. And then booting it into a big garbage can up here.
Yeah, and then in between, he would tell these little jokes and stuff, and they'd all end with like, because it's just awful. He's got no confidence. The joke would taper off to a...
He's got a CD of his appearances on our show.
Of course he does.
That he hands out.
Andrew's going to have a CD soon.
Oh, my God. A star in the mix.
Boys talking about killing.
Track 2.
Well, let me hear about it, potheads. I'm interested. No, Andrew. You know what? I hope Andrew full of shit. I got nothing against the man that does what he's told.
All right, let's play this Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young, or just
Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. Yeah, it's Wooden Ships, and it's by a band called Four Way Street out of California.
All right, let's check it out.
It's not legal for the actual members to make a tribute band, is it? You can't because no. That's just uncanny.
Something they have up on their site, though, they said that a woman that was the wardrobe. Mistress, something that worked directly with Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young, back in the early 70s.
Joni Mitchell.
They sounded absolutely. She said that this band sounds better live than Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young ever did.
Mm. Amazing.
Their harmonies are just like that.
That was good.
Spot on.
Well, we got to contact them again.
That was good. Yeah, get in touch with them.
I'll get in touch with them. The next track, if you want to suffer through this one, it's a band called Appetite for Destruction.
Uh oh.
They're local. We've played with them over at the downtown.
Yeah.
It's a Guns N' Roses tribute. And track 2 is November Rain.
Uh oh.
And you don't like this one, huh?
That song stinks to begin with.
He brought
I like that one.
He brought some good ones and some bad ones in for us today.
You know what he sounds like? Take Paul Williams and chop his balls off. Remember little Paul Williams?
Sounds like the Vietnamese singer in Full Metal Jacket. Away in my beautiful balloon.
He gets flatter and flatter as he goes, too. The drum. The drummer's got
Bonds!
The leader of an epileptic.
Bonds! Bonds!
What the fuck? Why didn't you do something, Lieutenant?
This ain't a tribute band, you piece of shit!
track 4 is a band called Livewire. These guys are probably the best AC/DC tribute band.
AC/DC.
And this is a totally live.
Is it Bon Scott AC/DC? Or?
No, it's Brian Johnson, and he does them extremely well.
All right.
All right. Really well.
Colin's rocking. Yeah, live.
Yeah, totally live. Yeah,
no, Jimmy's not going to do Angus.
Their Angus is killer, too, man. The guy looks just like him.
Is your Coke to your pleasure there?
I gave the guy money. I said, buy everybody what they want. I'm not out for number one.
No one wanted anything. I wanted money.
I wanted coffee or something.
I'd like a little something to eat.
Your money's no good here, Mr. Torrance.
You're not a shit.
Oh, no. Obligatory shining line of the day.
Oh, God help me. Tim, what's going on?
We're still up on 495. We haven't even made it to 109 yet. The traffic is horrendous out here.
All right, you're stuck in a huge traffic jam.
Yeah, I don't know if this is an accident or what the deal is. Uh-oh, I think a bike just stopped. All right, he's cool. All right, but that's the deal right now. We're still sitting out here on 495.
All right, so
guys.
The Wild Motorcycle Ride is going very slowly right now.
Tim?
What was that, Jimmy? You going to hang up on me?
No, I was wondering if there's a lot of traffic.
Oh, Jesus.
Strangely enough, yes, there is.
All right, let's go to Pat from Minaki.
Oh,
he's
hey.
Part of the Wild Motorcycle Ride, and he's got Andrew riding shotgun.
That's correct. Who needs hot broads flashing at this? I got Andrew.
How's the conversation in there, Pat?
Oh, it's wonderful.
What are you guys talking about?
We're talking about the traffic. We're talking about how much fun it's going to be down at the club we're going to. It'll be fun. I got nothing again.
Got a van. Is Andrew trying to figure out where he can buy a fake cast and a couch?
Would you?
Are you about a size 26?
That's good. He's good, man.
But then he goes,
well, not just saying.
So, Pat, are you behind the motorcycles? Tell us what's going on, man.
Well, as they merged into the tunnel, they got a little bit ahead. We're a little bit behind. Stuff from my behind is kind of big. So we're just sitting in traffic, waiting to get to the turnpike here.
All right. Well, can we speak to Andrew?
Why, yes, you can.
All right.
He's right here.
Yeah, and Pat's like, yeah. Here, Andrew.
How can I follow Pat?
Well, don't you.
Perfect.
Holy shit. So, Andrew, what's going on? What are you talking about with Pat from Menaki?
Hot dogs and eggnog. How I have 10 toes. I don't know.
Talking about the eggnog competition, a little bit. Getting to know each other.
Yeah.
I think they're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Did your mother have any children that lived? I bet you regret that.
So, you're having fun, Andrew?
Yes, I'm having a lot of fun right now.
Well, are you fucking tired, sweetheart?
Andrew, we're getting a request. Someone wants you to do a Paul Anka impression for us today.
Put your head on the shoulder of the road.
Because you are a disgusting fat body, Private Pile.
Andrew,
yes.
You still there?
Are you royalty?
What have we got here? A fucking comedian. Don't pull my fucking hand over there. I said choke yourself.
Choke yourself. Andrew, do you have a Paul Anka impression in you?
Everything else, huh? Andrew?
I'm thinking.
Oh, that's gotta hurt.
How about the guys get tits? Because it's Whip 'em Out Wednesday.
Guys get tits. Guys get tits. Don't make a fucking mania out of me. Guys get tits.
Don't make a fucking mania out of me. Don't make a fucking mania out of me. Well, not as bad as I thought it would be, though.
All right. Oh, you got nothing.
You two have fun.
All right.
Enjoy your ride down to Philly.
With all the traffic right now.
To Club Risque. Thank you. All right. There he goes. Our new creation, Andrew, with Pat from Menaki. Let's say hi to Taz from Whackbag. Taz?
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
Yeah, I just want to let you guys know, anyone who's listening in the motorcade over there, once you get on the turnpike, it's free sailing. I'm sitting right by 280 waiting for you guys to come up, join up with you.
Oh, very good. We got ourselves a convoy.
Hey, Taz. Taz? I hung up. He sent me a couple of fans. A couple of fans for the computer, but they were the wrong size.
Oh, really?
I'm still waiting for Dell. And by the way, I read another article on Dell. You know what they did? They were getting so many complaints about their customer service on the website. So instead of making customer service better, they shut down the website that you're able to complain on. they closed down the fucking website.
They cut out the middleman.
That's it.
There you go. Let's say hi to Jeff in New Jersey. Jeff?
Hey, I think that Pat and Andrew are going to become the retarded Lenny and Squiggy.
Retarded Lenny and Squiggy.
Very good.
We'll take off on those two mutants.
All right, thank you, Jeff.
Hello.
All right, punching out.
All right, let's get back to the tribute band thing with Brother Joe.
Yeah, we have another live wire if you want to hear it real quick. Dirty Deeds. track five. And
is this a live one or studio?
Yeah, live. No,
I want to hear your band.
I don't know if I have. Yeah, if you guys.
We got one laying around. We got to it. But we've got
laying around.
Diamonds and a six.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, this guy is just a killer performer too, man.
Yeah.
Chris Andros. Yeah, he absolutely kicks ass.
I disagree. That didn't sound like Joan Jett at all.
And Doug Out Doug wants to know, can he sing Hulkster in Heaven? You never find a Hulkamaniac.
You know what, man?
Band.
Go on. I swear to God, go on tributeband.com or tributecity.com.
Yeah.
You will find the tribute to anything, including Hulk Hogan.
Really?
Swear to God.
There's a Hulk Hogan
tribute. There's a Hulk Hogan tribute. There's an Aaron Carter tribute.
Oh really?
I mean, there are tributes.
Unnervingly, that's actually from Andrew.
We got to get the Hulk Hogan tribute thing.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, man. All
that.
Over the place.
Well, Livewire's got to be in the contest.
Yeah, Livewire's definitely. I figured they would be. They are the premier AC/DC tribute.
Yeah. That's a biggie.
In
what
the
else
United
you got?
States. Something for Rope, man. I found a band called Lounge Act, one of the few Nirvana tribute bands.
Ooh.
And it's a song about a girl. And these guys are French Canadian. They actually learned how to sing this stuff phonetically.
Really?
Yeah.
They don't speak English.
No. They don't speak English. Their whole website's
are they any good?
French. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, no, they're killer. They're really good.
Stupid Canadians.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
What track is that?
That is track six. So
they play in Mountie uniforms. which looks
no, they
silly.
Actually look very, very close. The Dave Grohl guy is scary.
Really?
And
so is Dave Grohl.
Very good. Kurt Cobain guy.
Yeah,
yeah.
Pull it off looks wise.
Absolutely.
I don't like that big bass player. He reminds me of Phil from the Poker.
Yeah.
Wow, I never thought of that. Chris Novoselic kind of looks like Phil Gordon, the Poker player.
Yeah.
Well, let's take a listen.
Is it true he sits on a moose as he sings this song? Stupid Canadians.
Ugh. And they don't know English?
No.
That's amazing.
Frere Shaka.
They're good, though.
Dumb and blue. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, not bad.
We should get them in the contest.
Yeah, we should. It's
man, Joe made this job a lot easier. A
lot easier than weeding through the shit we've had to look at.
We've had hundreds of things come in, and we didn't even know where to begin.
Just ask, man.
Yeah.
I'm there for the...
Well, Joe will organize this whole thing.
Hell yeah.
Pass this on to you.
I'll put it all together. Gladly, I'll put it together.
I'll be honest, that Axl Rose guy, it was bad, but he sounded like Steve Marriott, who we mentioned before. died in a fire, tragically.
Yeah, smoking in bed.
Let's say hi to Terry in Arizona. Terry.
Hey. That was a bad impression. Can I hear some Brother Joe up in here?
Yeah, we'll go to break with up in here.
I appreciate it. Later, boys.
Thanks, Terry.
All right, from Arizona, huh?
We're all over the place now.
Oh, nice.
All right, what do you got?
I have a band called 2112, the best Rush tribute.
Rush is rough, man.
Yeah, we listened to a couple Rush bands. That were just really rough.
Here you go. Track 7, Tom Sawyer. You tell me if this
Rush
isn't
bands.
Rush.
Rush bands, tributes always have the guy that just might as well have that helium balloon.
You know Anthony, though, man. No, you've heard Anthony before.
Yep.
And this guy's fantastic.
Yeah. That's why you got to weed through so many bad Rush tributes.
They have an Asian bass player we like to call Geddy Ree.
There you go. A little racism in in the band there.
Here
there
is proof that Keith the Cop has Stalker Patty on the back of his bike.
Oh. Yeah, there it is. Oh, my God, she's wearing a helmet. Is she wearing one of those, like, Nazi helmets?
Oh.
That's great. I'm a Nazi. That's wonderful.
And,
Sieg Heil.
I think
Heil Hitler. If she was a Nazi, if she was Eva Braun, Hitler would have killed himself in 1941.
Bunker.
Hey, Hitler. All Hitler would have needed was some chocolates. It would have cheered him up. It would have fixed the whole problem. Some chocolate-covered strawberries.
A lot of pictures going up on opieandanthony.com and video. So let's say hi to Keith the Cop. He's on the line here. Keith?
Hey, fellas. What's going on?
All right. I hear it's slow moving so far, huh?
All right. We are finally out of the tunnel and all the traffic. We are at the Alexander Hamilton rest stop, which is the first one on the turnpike.
Hey, stick in the glory hole for me, would you?
See a little bit of that here.
What?
Smooth sailing from here, hopefully. I am very glad that I left my gun at home because I had to put a bullet in Patty's fucking head about it. She does not shut the fuck up.
What is she saying?
Oh, look, the movie that's only $2. It's probably a grand opening that's $8 again.
Oh, my God.
He talked about fucking everything.
Could you imagine that being right behind you?
No.
The entire ride is babbling about movie prices.
You know, Keith is on vacation and he wanted to have a little fun on his vacation. He's in hell. He's truly doing this for us.
Oh, I have such a problem finding shoes since my hammer toe surgery. I go to a place that's right there on 57th or 56th and Broadway, and they have good shoes, but a lot of times they bunch up after walking for a while, and when I'm working, shut up!
At that point, I'd pop a wheelie until I heard a scraping sound.
Jesus. All right, what else is going on, Keith? How many bikes do we have? Are people joining the ride? Give us the details.
I didn't even think there was that many when we pulled out of 57th Street, but holy shit, it went all the way down to 7th Avenue. I think we got about 125 right now. We picked up a couple down here at the first rest stop, so. A
lot of people requesting that you guys wait up for some of the cars.
Yeah, we got a couple of the cars. We're going to hang out about 5 more minutes here at the rest stop.
Okay.
I got to make Club Risqué on airtime, you know?
All right. And what's the deal with the truckers and stuff? You getting a lot of support on the highway?
Oh, absolutely. I think everybody heading into New York on those fucking buses, Jesus Christ, there's a ton of them. But I think everybody got a nice flash on the way into New York. They'll have a nice story to tell around the water cooler today.
A lot of flashing going on, Anthony. Very
Bravo.
Nice. Whip them out Wednesday in full effect today. Thanks to Keith the Cop and the gang.
Keith and Patty.
All right, I will check in from the next stop.
All right, yeah, you can check in just before you take off.
You see, Keith's head explode, man. I never seen brains like that before.
All right. Sounds good.
All right, thanks, Keith.
Bye.
All right. There he goes.
Let's do it for Pat and Andrew.
Right. So we got
Manny.
Manny.
2112, track 7, Tom Sawyer.
Well, these guys got to be in the contest, too.
No doubt. I think they blow away the last Rush tribute you guys listened to.
Yeah.
We're going to have rounds and stuff, because now there's a lot of bands that we have to get to.
Where was that that CD? I think Ben had it. He was goofing on me about it, the No Doubt tribute.
Oh, yeah, I got it right here.
Is the chick any good? I've heard
of them. I don't know. I've heard about them. I haven't heard them, though.
Tragic Kingdom, yep. Yeah, they're off Long Island.
What do you want to hear, Underneath It All or Just a Girl?
Just a girl.
All right, this is
just a girl.
The No Doubt tribute band that sent in some stuff.
But
we haven't heard them yet.
We have to hear the rap on Underneath It All.
I understand, but
I've heard mixed reviews.
Have you?
Yeah.
Tragic Kingdom, everyone.
We will decide. It's not awful, but there's something I can't put my finger on.
I'll tell you exactly what it is. She's not doing the impression. She's not doing the impression.
Yeah.
She's a girl singing,
but
No Doubt.
If she's as hot or hotter than Gwen Stefani, it's
she's
acceptable.
In. There you go. Yeah.
If she's not as hot, she has some balls doing it.
Some set of balls.
She sounds like the guy from the Rush tribute band. Maybe it is him.
Just Anthony throwing a wig on, are you saying? All right, that's Tragic Kingdom. Not bad from Long Island.
You put on Fat Bob so I can go back and try to get some well-needed sleep. You're going to put them on today, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at you. Well, you can hang out till the end of the show.
Or put Bob on, suck it up.
I'm the producer.
Or how about to the end of the segment, at least? Jesus.
Yeah.
Well.
We're almost at break. We're almost at break. Ooh. What else you got here, Joe?
I have one thing left, though. This is from Argentina. It's a band called 3 AM. It's two guys that do Simon and Garfunkel.
From Argentina?
From Argentina. They don't speak a word of English either, and it's quite apparent.
Although I will say, if you play Bob, you can just put that under the Orca tribute band.
track 8. You know, Argentina exports a lot of oil.
Track 8 is subdivisions,
and
if you want to hear that quick.
Lots of textiles as an export. Shut up.
Shut up. How funny is it that Voss never made it in? He is in Virginia.
Stupid Voss.
Huh? If you want to know. What?
What does Ben say?
Ben, I was hoping a napkin with a gem would show up.
If you want another little taste of 2112, track 8 is subdivisions.
Nah, they're already in. That's obvious.
Cool.
Yeah.
So this is Argentina
this
guys.
This is a couple of Argentina guys doing Simon and Garfunkel, a band called 3 AM.
All right.
I saw my horse and carriage is for hire, senora.
Wow.
For just as long as you desire, senorita.
We're gonna ride, forget the mañana, and come to Havana with me.
Oh. Babalu.
You joined a gang.
Yeah.
There's so many hysterical bands up on Tribute City.
2-1, 2-1. We're down with the Simon and Garfunkel.
I have to go home and write an essay.
What about the new hot band, tribute bands on the island that I'm into? Crystal Ship.
There you go.
Rat Race Choir.
Joey Russo. Right?
Rat Race Choir.
Rat Race Choir. Actually, the drummer that I have now, I picked up. The new drummer in the U2 band is Vinny Tatinelli from 9 Days. That band, 9 Days.
It's a bad. You guys are like the most incestuous area for bands is Long Island, and it's everybody knows everybody from every other band. You all play with each other. You get like band aids.
Only
you should
the
all
good
have
ones,
AIDS.
Man. Only the decent ones.
Well, the funniest is the guys that used to go to the Brooklyn Club, like you know,
Lemoore's.
Yeah, and they'd be and they'd be like, "When the music's over," and then stick accents.
Oh man, Lemoore's. I remember playing that.
Lemoore, yeah.
All right, let's thank Brother Joe. You got to come in with more examples.
This
is great, and we're gonna have a contest eventually. We got to figure it out. Or at least a little tribute concert featuring you guys.
You guys,
yeah, some of these other bands.
You do remember? You remember that band 9 Days that did "Story of a Girl"? Mm-mm. This is the story of a girl. That song. You remember that song?
Yeah.
Oh, they were huge on whatever on the radio. They
I don't remember them.
Anyway, Vinny is now playing with us, and he is making more with a tribute band and doing better with this tribute band, being treated better. Everywhere we go to play than he ever was with 9 Days, who was signed to Sony, had a major deal, $1 million publishing deal. He saw like no
money.
It's
the typical story. Everyone gets fucked.
Yep, absolutely.
The record companies.
So, he's
I used to have posters of these guys on my walls. Now I'm living the dream.
All right, very good, Brother Joe.
All right, guys.
We actually are going to go to break with one of your classic songs up in here.
Love this one.
We get so many requests for this song, it's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Basically, Brother Joe did James Taylor doing DMX.
Right.
James Taylor doing DMX.
Maybe for the truckers and the hillbillies, we should play a little bit of DMX just so they understand what's going on here.
Oh, no, that
song. Everyone remembers this song. Come
you
on.
Look
at Hawk. Look at Hawk racing.
Up in here.
A little sweat off the brow, Hawk. Can you get it in time? Taking a long time already.
Yeah,
the lead should be in there.
It's not frozen. Hit the button.
So there you have it. Up in here by DMX. And Brother Joe took that song and sang it as James Taylor, basically.
Only how James Taylor could sing it.
You guys called his home number?
We don't have his home number.
Well, you have a cell, though. And he always answers his cell.
Oh,
it's wedged between his stomach.
Hold my hand, man. All right, because we got some audio. Bob Kelly losing it at a comedy club.
Do you have his home number, Eric, or no?
They're working on it, dude.
Don't snap at anybody, Jim. He's right here on pen. Please don't snap at people, Jim.
Producer Jim.
Yeah, I know you've been quiet all day. Now you're going to start bellyaching.
I took a melatonin last night, man. Like, I took them high.
You did?
Yeah.
Well, who told you to take one, silly?
I couldn't sleep, and I wanted to get some rest.
That's not work.
I had a yoga.
Does that work?
Yeah, but it took 3 hours, so it, like, fucking...
That's just falling asleep. So 3 hours. You fell asleep, idiot.
I finally fell asleep, like, and I just... Then it just knocks you out, man.
Yeah,
like,
right, but what he was saying was that if you took 3 hours, it doesn't really work.
No, I know. But I was saying that the effect of the drug is still there, even though it took 3 hours.
All right, Bob Kelly.
And I wanted to take yoga.
What's up?
Oh. You just woke up?
Yeah, I'm a fucking human being.
Oh, my God. What are you, on Vicodin?
No.
He was on Vicodin.
Yes.
Yeah.
But he's off it now.
Vicodin's the
Hold
best.
My hand, man.
Hold my hand, man.
Hold my
What's
hand.
The matter? You were sleeping.
Yeah, I was sleeping. Fucking Anthony. I was fucking out. Out of my fucking head.
Dude, you're supposed to promote your Caroline's appearance with
Colin.
With Colin
Quinn. I ain't promoting that shit. That's Colin's fucking gig. I don't want my fucking two fans to show up and ruin it.
People are going to be yelling things out at you? Have they been doing that lately?
I don't want sink fucker and you stink.
Hold my hand, man.
Oh, that one, too.
We miss you on the show, man.
Hey, I miss you, too.
Not Jimmy. You!
Thanks for stopping by.
Hey, Bob.
Thanks for stopping by, Jim.
Bob, what do you... I've been busy, man. I'm sorry. I want to go by and just look at you sitting there in a fucking cast.
You fucking selfish... $1 million apartment owning douchebag.
So, hey, listen, I don't want to just sit there and look at you fucking groaning, you fat Grossberger on a couch with your bad leg sticking out. I want to kick it. That's why I don't show up, because I'm tempted to kick your injury.
Look how angry you are this morning. Jesus
I'm
Christ.
Just tired.
Is he in a cast now?
I don't know what he's in. He's just laying there on a sofa.
Bob, have you gotten
that leg sticking out?
Have you gotten it fixed yet?
Yeah, I got it fixed like 2 weeks ago.
What did they do to it?
They went inside. There was a piece of ligament, like a shark's tooth, floating around in my knee.
Yeah.
That they put onto a keychain and put it around my neck. Nice talking to you. Then I went. Then they scraped some cartilage out.
Yeah.
And then they heated up. They got a laser beam, like Battlestar Galactica.
Nice topical reference to a laser. Sure.
Thanks. And they heated up my ligament on my ACL and made it shrink up, so it tightened up.
Oh.
Yeah, there was worse pain than when I did it.
Are you on painkillers now?
No. Right now, I'm with Sun Life.
All right, well. I heard you lost it at a comedy club.
Yeah, we've been hearing about this clip that's making the rounds on the internet that you just unloaded on a heckler and wouldn't stop.
Oh, yeah.
Just silently agree.
Andrew.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, can you set it up? I mean, we have the clip. We're going to play it.
Can you do something? Jesus.
Can you maybe tell us what happened when you were on stage?
Oh, man. You know what? Jim.
Yes.
How you doing?
Good. I'm very tired today.
You've been on stage a bunch of times, and you just look out and you see that. You're doing great. The crowd's great. It's not you. They're having a good time. You're doing good. And there's that one just piece of shit. Keeping their head down, won't make eye contact.
The club owner?
Yeah.
And then they try to laugh. They try to laugh. And they kind of, like, put their head down and cover their mouth.
Yeah.
Like they're fighting it. They don't want to like you one bit.
Are you sure? Are you sure you're not talking about one person laughing and the rest of the club people looking down?
It might have been that. But that's not the point. Wow, Jim's on fire.
Dude, I fucking had nothing to say all day. I've been very sleepy.
God damn.
But I'm going to come see you tonight, man. I know you've been on the mend.
You're going to come see me tonight?
Oh,
2 weeks
tomorrow
after
night?
It's happened. I can walk to your house by now, Jim. Yeah. You don't need to come see me.
Well, I got
to
pick up mail.
You got to get... Yeah, there you go. Douche.
All right, do we...
You know,
Steve, broke my heart, Jimmy.
You know Steve Burns? We got him here today, too.
Oh, Steve. Good for him.
Hello, Robert.
Oh, yeah.
What's wrong with Steve Burns, bro?
Robert.
I'll tell you what. You know what's wrong with Steve Burns? He's a good kid, funny kid, but you know, we all bust each other's balls and make fun of each other. Every
funny
time
kid.
I do,
all right, Milton Berle.
I know, he sounds like Tommy Cuomo.
Funny kid, but I don't think he'll make it into business.
He don't respect anyone. He has a head of rock with an Asian haircut on it. Let's play this awful tape.
Yeah, why don't we get to the tape?
Yeah.
I'm going to come see you, Bob. You know what Bob looks like right now? You ever see, like, when they go to wake LaMotta up at the end of the movie? Champ.
She looks 16 to you.
I introduce him to men.
Oh. What do you have in the studio today? Dog the Bounty Hunter? Is that who's in today?
No, it's,
Wow.
I was going to speak, and I said, you know what? Let that one
just
there.
Let it sit. Good.
All right, Brother Joe.
Yeah, hold on a second. Let's say hi to Jim. Jim?
Hi, guys. We're down. We're just passing Newark Airport. We're finally rolling back down,
Are you fucking pushing the motorcycles? You left 2 hours ago. Holy shit.
Yeah, this is the update on the Jim motorcycle ride. They're going all the way to Club Risque in Philly. We got Jim on the phone, and you guys are only on the New Jersey Turnpike near...
Newark Airport.
Newark Airport.
Yeah, Jimmy, we held in traffic coming out of the tunnel. We had people actually off the bikes. That's how bad the traffic was.
Oh, must have been bumper to bumper, right?
Strangely enough, yes. And I'm going to keep answering your questions like that when you ask them like that.
Right, this is part of the Eisenhower Interstate project that started after the war. We decided to shut up.
Shut up.
You know what I'm talking about, Lieutenant? No, I don't, Elias. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
What else you got, Jim?
Not much. Hey, Jimmy. I know it ain't going to work. It was worth a shot. Bye, guys.
All right, thank you. All right, more people joining the Wild Motorcycle Ride as they make their way to Philly. All right, Bob, back to you. We're going to play the audio of you losing it on stage.
You guys are making it good. You can have more than one person online at the same time now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
I just heard Bob yelling at somebody. He said, why don't you put the dishes where they're not going to fall?
These are the jewels from the belt. This is the cartilage from the knee.
The knee of a failure is a very rare item, Mr. LaMotta.
This is the cartilage from the knee.
All right, let's get
even
to the audio.
You don't know what you mean, Dawn. You put you with them.
Oh, what? Great.
Bob's taking a piss.
Bob's taking a piss.
I think he's draining his knee.
Colin Quinn at Caroline's all weekend long.
Hi, Colin. Are you there, Colin?
Hello, Robert.
Oh, I hate that.
Why?
I hate the fuck.
He hates my impression of Steve.
I hate tone. Either say something, Steve Burns, that's what he'd say. I call him an unfunny chink or something. Robert, is that the road you want to go down?
Are you done pissing and shaking it off?
But what? Yeah.
Is he still pissing?
Yeah, dude, I drink a lot of liquid.
Just don't spill any drinks on the senator's wife. Colin! Bring me a crutch. Something happened here.
you motherfucker. You're on fire. Jesus Christ.
All right, Bob, we're going to finally play the audio of losing it.
I was tackling him in a football game. A couple of foot pounds per second per second.
I wouldn't hurt one hair on his fat, misshapen head.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Your scale is no good here, Mr. Torrance.
Oh, God, here we go.
Hey, Bob, what happened with this guy on stage? You were telling that joke where you say, my wife gives me a beautiful bath. Hey, what time does your wife get home? And the crowd was...
Father's a degenerate.
A degenerate. Did I say that?
What's Colin doing? Is Colin
going to
say? Is he
going to
smash?
Colin did enough today already. He just could sit and enjoy now.
Colin's had
working all morning while Norton was sitting there lump.
He had a lot of funny in the first couple hours
Colin
of the show.
Colin is eagerly awaiting this audio.
Give us the setup. Where
Colin's
were you, Bob?
Petering out.
They were in Houston, right?
I was in Houston.
In Houston. This guy's sitting there.
In Houston. It's so weird, too, because... The 3rd through the 6th, I'm going to be back at this club in August.
Oh, that's very weird.
And that's, I'm scared a little bit.
Why? Because it's always good to plug 2 months out.
Yeah, if you have one show, I'm sorry, I'm not a million-dollar apartment owner, you jack-off.
No, but you are fat with a broken leg. How do you like them apples?
Well,
stuck in your mouth while you're roasted.
You have HIV.
Jim Norton has woken up, everyone. Watch out.
Yes.
All right, Bob, we got to play the audio here.
Yeah. Right,
so this one guy is sitting there. He's got his, he wants to laugh, thinks Bob is funny, but he doesn't like Bob and doesn't want to laugh. So he's sitting there kind of trying hard not to laugh just to show.
Everybody around him.
Yeah. Everyone around him is laughing.
Even the people at his table thought it was funny.
Right.
So you're in Dallas and this guy's just being a dick.
Oh, my God. This setup's so fucking, you guys are being so nice to me that I'm getting nervous now.
Why?
Nice. We've done nothing but hammer you since you picked up the phone.
And I haven't hammered you, Bob. I just was happy to talk to you, and you started being mean to me because I haven't come to visit you.
I love you, Jimmy.
What do you say there, Bob?
Hey.
Can
I just say it? The only friend that's called me, Colin Quinn.
Thank you.
Because Colin's a fucking idiot who just needs to hear himself talk, and you happen to be the one who picked up. You think I don't see CQ on my fucking caller ID and just let it ring?
Bob, can we play the audio?
I'm sorry, Opie. I don't mean to fuck up your show.
Jesus Christ.
All right, here we go. Let's play the audio.
Oh, God. Dude, you all right, dude? You all right? Because I'm fucking killing up here, and you're just looking at it. You can smell dog shit, but you don't know where it is. You all right? Did something? Your dog die? A blister on your toe? Did you lose a nut to cancer? What happened? You okay, dude? All right, dude. That's just your personality. It's like a little fucking, you stare at the ground and you think about the hookers in your trunk. Fucking serial killer. Can you fucking lighten up? Either that or go to the back. It's dark. I don't have to look at your fucking smug face.
That's really cool that you looked at his smug face. Because, dude, a lot of times people act smug and that's irritating. But when somebody is smug... That really bothers me.
But when you have fans, Jimmy, they let you get away with things like that.
Oh, no, I know. I got to go to L.A. I just hope the schmog isn't too bad. You're a shithead. Do you know that?
You know, and you're a critic is what you are. You're a critic.
Critic.
Ooh.
You're a critic.
Well, that's gonna hurt.
I know.
Fucking serial killer, can you fucking lighten up? You just gotta go to the back. It's dark. I don't have to look at your fucking smug face. I hope she's still alive. I hope she's still alive because I want to fuck her one more time before she dies. And then when she's dead, I'm gonna fuck her 8 more times.
Character work.
Yeah.
Pretty good, right?
I'm just fucking with you.
Think it was the real person.
He really is. You're just staring over this way. It's like you're afraid, like I fucking molested you when you were 8. Don't come over and touch me right there. Him, Mr. Funny Man, slipped on my little baby pod. Like this.
Wait, I'm not. Kyle wanted to say something.
What?
What? Oh.
Kyle's pointing at his mouth. What?
Yeah. I want to know if that when you said like this, you mimicked somebody sucking. I want to know if when you said he's sucking my baby pud, which is of course inexcusable, but then you mimicked somebody sucking on a little cock. Is that what happened right then?
No.
Yeah, I'll get the fucking videotape if I have to.
You can get a videotape.
Continue.
What did you do then?
I just said it, but then I think I kind of went a little overboard.
What is like this? Then what happened?
What
follows?
What
mimicking did you do, Mr. Funny Man?
I don't know. Look at the whole end of your set.
What was that? What does that mean?
You mean when you go?
I don't do. I haven't done that since 1995.
Shut up!
I won't shut up.
You do it every 20 seconds.
No, I don't.
Yeah. Slip by.
You don't think I'm funny?
Slip by.
Get the fuck out, faggot! Well,
hey,
then get the fuck out, free faggot! This one, that one, all these motherfuckers are fine with what the fuck I'm doing. You get the fuck. Because you're staring at me, you fucking piece of shit. Get the fuck up and leave.
How did you get footage of Lenny Clark bombing?
Who's Lenny Clark?
Lenny. He's like you, but
like
a little
Lenny.
Thinner. No, how the fuck? How the fuck? Some guy's minding his own business from what I could hear.
Oh, no.
Being a little passive. You turned on him so hard, called him a faggot, told him to get the fuck
out. I got to side with Bob on this one. That guy, that face, and believe me, Kyle, you've seen that face. That guy just fucking moping up front. You want to smash his face, and Bob couldn't take it anymore. I got to say,
but
I
wait
side
a minute.
With Bob.
Don't you think he went from 0 to 60?
No.
That was, really that was building the whole
side. Please watch the progression.
You didn't hear it. This was 30 minutes into the set.
Right.
I let it go for 30 minutes.
You let what go? The guy was screaming at you the whole time, heckling? Like,
No.
And 30 minutes? Whoa, since when did an MC do 30 minutes up front?
Dude, you gotta rewind a little bit, because I think me and Bob were talking over the part where the guy said you're not funny or something.
Yeah, I said, what the fuck? I just said, get out. And then he goes, I said something. He goes, you're not funny.
All right, let's take
and
a look.
Then,
right, then you're
he
right.
Goes, it was a free ticket.
All right, then you're right. I'm sorry. I didn't hear that.
Well, then get the fuck out, free faggot!
Good. OB, not far enough!
Oh.
OB!
Sorry.
Not for Pete's sake.
Don't yell at OB.
I'm not funny? You don't think I'm funny? Then get the fuck out, faggot!
No, you're right. Good. Chop the rabbit! He brought us here!
Out, free faggot! This one, that one, all these motherfuckers are fine with what the fuck I'm doing. You get the fuck.
The right starting shit.
Because you're staring at me, you fucking piece of shit. Get the fuck up and leave. Why would you? This is my point. If I went somewhere and it sucked and I hated it, I don't give a fuck if it was free, if they gave me $85 to go with it and suck my asshole in the bathroom. I'd get the fuck out. Because you know what? I don't give a fuck, dude. If it's free or not, fuck you, leave. If you don't like my humor, get the fuck out. That's what. Why would you stay? Have a spine, be a man, get the fuck up, stand up, and say, this show sucks and I'm the fuck out. If I'm fucking torturing you, get the fuck out. All right. I don't need your fucking manners, nor do I need your fucking sympathy, motherfucker. I'm a funny motherfucker. This is what I do, bitch. I don't need you to go, well, I think you're good. Fuck you. Beat it. Go back and when fucking some fucking asshole with
He stinks, and I don't like him.
I gotta side with Bob on that one. Very good. Yeah. That guy sounded like a real cocksucker, and I'm glad you smashed him.
Well, you know what happened? Is right when I was giving that dumb rant, an old couple got up and left.
Yeah, they don't want to hear you like a psychopath up on stage yelling at the audience. They might be next.
I love the rant, by the way. I love it.
How funny would that have been if Bob said, if you don't like it, just leave, and everybody got up and just walked out. And only that guy stayed.
I see the awful, terrible things in my life and turn it into something funny.
Mom! I'm not going to lower it. I have to do this now.
Wait, could you please...
Yeah?
Could you play the thing where he starts going up and saying how funny he is at the end, and then just imagine a 7-year-old locked out in his backyard with a parent not talking to him. They have taken care of the other kids, get better Christmas gifts.
I went back. I think I got it. Sorry.
Nor do I need your fucking sympathy, motherfucker. I'm a funny motherfucker. This is
what
I do.
Who are you yelling at, Bob?
Bitch, I don't need you to go, well, I think you're good. Fuck you.
Well, mommy.
Beat it! Go back and when fucking some fucking asshole with a case and fucking props comes back... And
some asshole with good marks in school. Who lives next door with good marks in school? That makes the fucking football team, Mom!
I don't like the cheap shot he took at Carrot Top there.
Yeah, I know. That's one of Carrot Top's crowning bits.
I wasn't making fun of Carrot Top.
Gallagher?
He's making fun of people that make fun of Carrot Top.
All right, let's say hi to Greg in Baltimore. Greg, go ahead.
Hey, the comedians get smiles. The comedians get smiles. Don't make a fucking maniac out of me. The comedians get smiles.
What's that from?
He was trying to do it.
I don't find that funny. I felt the same way as Kelsey in the fucking arena.
Is there any audio or video of that?
Nah.
I thought somebody had something. They said they were going to send
God, that would be great.
I want to know who said I did good character work. Was that you, Colin?
That was Colin.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And you were doing that to that Southern guy.
Yo, I love your character work on stage.
Uh-oh. You'll see it this weekend.
It involves the same voice, the same Michael Caine face.
At least it's
to the right.
At least this weekend I'll be able. Your characters are going to have a pronounced limp.
I like Michael Caine face.
Thanks. Well, we were waiting for you to decide what the fucking. Shut your mouth. Who cares what you like? Go back to sleep.
I like
another. Take another fucking.
Put on a blonde wig and cut a throat in an elevator.
I might do that.
All right. Let's get back to the audio here. He continues with this guy.
Oh. Uncomfortable moment.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Grow a spine and get the fuck out. Don't worry about your drink. I'll take care of your drink. I got it. It's on me, motherfucker. But are you with him? Did you drive him? Does he have a car? You need a ride home? I'll hook you up, motherfucker. If you want to stay. No, because you're laughing. You're having fun, right? This fucking miserable, grumpy fucking Muppet is in the balcony just looking down. I don't fucking like this show at all. You fucking, what the fuck?
Wait, the guy was in a balcony?
Yeah.
No wonder you were so brave.
How did you see him?
I'm sitting there wondering why you're so brave.
He wasn't in the balcony.
No, he wasn't in a balcony.
He was doing a... Wow. He was doing a Muppet reference to the old man in the balcony.
Okay, I'm
Holy
sorry.
Shit. And he really did have a spine. It was just like kind of speaking metaphorically.
Right, that's a good one, though.
Get him a drink.
Yeah, he really didn't look like a baby cock either.
Well, but I was wondering, I mean, was this guy a big guy or something?
No, what do you think, I'm stupid?
That's what I was getting at. So when I heard balcony, I was only half listening. I'm thinking, well, wow, that's why he's brave.
So what?
This guy's in the front row of the balcony.
There was a gang of them at the table.
Dude, what did the guy eventually just turn around and wheel himself out?
There's the line.
Someone is suggesting Steve go to work and work his magic on this little rant and make a TV edit out of it.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Cut out all the dirty words.
We'll have to explain that to Colin after this bit.
Yeah. You'd have to explain it to me, too.
Oh, Bob, I missed
it. All right, let's finish up the audio here.
What the fuck? Dude, don't fucking bow your head because you're embarrassed because he's your friend. Fuck you. Laugh your ass off. Have fun, motherfucker. Fuck him. Fuck him and his fucking 6 feet under personality. Fuck him. See, they're leaving. They have a spine. Bye, sir. I respect you and your wife. I'd walk out of my fucking dirty ass too. But fuck you. If you think, what are you staring at me now? I don't give a fuck. Why do you go sit in the back and just be miserable in the back? Why would you sit there? It's a free show. You don't like it? Go sit
here enjoying the fucking show. Hey, what's up? Ha ha. Hoo hoo. You should fucking with them, because every time I say something funny, he's gonna look at you like you're his fucking girlfriend and go, is that okay? That's good. Okay.
No.
You understand? Go sit in the back, dude. Do us both a favor. Go sit in the back. Relax.
Go.
Huh? Oh, you just wanna do that shit? You wanna be like, you wanna fucking fuck?
I'd start getting pissed now if I was in the crowd.
Oh, you spoiled I'd fucking start getting pissed.
Brat. Be like, come on.
I'm sorry to all you other motherfuckers to stop the show. I'm sorry.
And there you have it.
I haven't heard voice inflection like that since Queen Latifah hosted the Colored Ladies of Laughter.
Yeah, you got a little black in you there.
Motherfucker, I don't want to sit in the back, sit up front. Mm-hmm.
Monique.
That's how you scare the white people in Houston.
Right, let's
what you
got
to do, you got to add a little black to your voice and they get all, they know you're not messing around down there.
Let's go to Alabama. Lance, what's up?
Hey, Bob.
Lance, just a flare.
Hey, I broke my knee, man. Hold my hand, please. Please hold my hand.
Jesus Christ. I love Alabama. I love when they call this show. All right, thank you, Lance. Well, Bob, that was very interesting. You did a good job there.
Thank you, Opie.
You really let the guy have it both barrels.
Did you get close to attacking him or anything like that?
Did I what?
Get close to attacking him?
You know what? At one point he tried to stare me down at the end.
And what happened after the show? Did you see him?
I stood by the over by the bar where they walk out, but he just left. But you know what? Right after that, at the end of the show, he wound up laughing. He started laughing and having a good time, and it kind of annoyed me. And then I felt kind of bad because I at the end of the show, I go, what do you do? And he told me he worked in a printing press. And I was like, oh, he's probably just a fucking idiot.
Well, maybe just a hardworking guy who has trouble showing his emotions and was enjoying the whole show until you were telling
him. Yeah, works in a printing press all day, figures he's going to go out for a night out on the town, have a little fun, and he gets berated by some limping maniac.
You know, and just show people your psychotic,
some mad
introverted
Tibetan
personality and stare at the floor and try not to laugh.
Some mad fucking Tibetan maniac. Some warlord from fucking
not everybody can
Genghis Khan's fat goddamn.
Not everybody can deal with looking out in the crowd and seeing people not laughing and be comfortable. With it, Colin.
Ooh.
Oh, wow, that wasn't Colin, bad. I like that one.
He's implying, hold on a second, he's implying that you stink.
Oh, I get it.
And you're used to people giving you that look.
Oh, I get it.
You fuck.
Shut up. I tell you what Bobby is. He's the Buddha's thug cousin. Like, you ever saw a picture of any of the Buddhas in history, and there's always a cousin with a leather jacket next to them in the middle of some Tibetan Himalayan mountain. It's Bobby.
Did you just call me a fucking Buddhist thug cousin?
Yes.
Yeah. Bob, they're telling me we have to let you be.
Who's they, Opie? Who is they? You're
but Opie's
they.
Inner clock who wants the show to be successful.
Yes.
You're they. There's no they. There's a bunch of free
Jimmy, is there people telling us that he has to be?
Yes, there's a they. It's people in studio and everyone listening.
All right, guys. I'll talk to you guys.
How is your knee healing at all?
Yeah, nice talking to you.
I'm asking, actually.
Yeah, it's better now.
How many more weeks you got, you think, on your back and stuff?
This is the first gig you're doing back, man. I haven't seen you at the Cellar in weeks.
I'm going to work with Colin this weekend.
I know that, but I'm saying I haven't seen you at the Cellar in weeks.
Yeah, I couldn't even
Don't mention the club, by the way, you idiot.
Shut up.
Caroline's all weekend long.
Why don't you describe where it really is to you? Directly across from Dunkin' Donuts and Krispy Kremes.
Man holding in his own kneecap can drink from my canteen anytime.
He drink patty water.
Colin, I forgot what you wanted me to say about you when I brought you up this week, so if you want to email that to me again.
Put the coffee down. Coffee is for closers. You call yourself a comedian, you son of a bitch.
Anyways,
here's Colin's intro. You might recognize your headliner if you have VCR tapes.
I swear, I hope he chokes to death right now. And Dawn makes a quick decision and says, fuck it.
I didn't even say it, you fucking
hell. Shut up, you cap.
It wasn't even me.
You laughed too much. You enjoyed it too much.
It was Gollum sitting next to you.
Gollum.
Say something to Precious. I didn't say nothing.
Leave half-formed larvae alone.
All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Have fun for the rest of the show.
All right,
thanks,
Bobby.
Thanks, sincerity, idiot.
Yeah, nice well-wishings. Smoking, sit there with your sore legs, stupid.
I just said have fun.
That's what we don't like is sincerity. Nice.
Exactly.
Do you understand?
Shut up!
Yeah. That is?
How hard is it for you to jerk off with your one leg straight under the computer desk? You fucking sex addict creep. He's got his leg against the electrical socket. His foot keeps getting zapped.
I had to move my power and my woofer.
Rotten straight leg just sticking out. Like cigarette ashes on it.
Yeah, well. It's nice talking to you.
Yeah, whatever.
Thanks for coming over and visiting me, Norton.
Dude, I swear I'm going to come by and see you as soon as you're up and about.
Do me a favor. Don't bring any chicks over when you come by.
Oh, yeah, I brought donkey sausage.
Why'd you do that?
I didn't, actually. That was Colin.
Shut your mouth, you lying
No,
punk.
I'm not lying.
Bobby, you know exactly what happened.
Absolutely
when
not.
When she sat there, she was being a little inappropriate. And then we go, Norton, could you please keep your women in line?
How was she being inappropriate?
Like, she was, like, Bob was sitting with Dawn, and he was kind of, like, injured on the couch. It's kind of late at night. You know, we're kind of being semi-human. And she's leading him going, shut up, Bob, you fucking idiot. Not with these tits. And, like, Dawn's like...
Oh, right, right.
It was me, Colin, Keith, and
she was
her.
On. She was, like, being on, and everybody's just kind of hanging out.
Being a little overt sexual. And
right, right.
She's my friend, but she's not my girl. Yeah. Why would I take responsibility for someone else's... unless you take responsibility for Keith.
I do take responsibility for all the Keiths in our country, if you know what I'm saying.
When fucking Keith walked in and he took off his red jacket and he left his lantern outside the door, I'm like, that is just absolutely rude.
Every time somebody comes out of the IND train with any blood, I go, I apologize for Keith and all his friends. You know? I think it's offensive what they do.
All right. Bobby.
Yo, run it.
Oh, we got rid of Bobby.
Who brought her over Bobby's house, though?
She just Jim!
No, I didn't. I was telling
no,
my
someone
brother.
Had to bring her.
She was just coming. We were all sitting there, and she said we were going. It was your idea to go see Bob. I'm like, yeah, I'll go see
Bob. Yeah, it was my idea to visit my friend who was injured. You're right.
Yes,
I'm responsible. So.
I'm a creep.
He wants to go, and a whole gaggle of people
that
followed.
Was the way it was just kind of happening. I didn't say, hey, you want to come?
Okay, do you want to hear the exact words that happened since this guy has a selective memory?
Thin fingers? What?
I was sitting there.
Shut up, AIDS hands.
AIDS hands?
Yeah, your sickly hands really bother me.
I do. I am awful. But
I'm
sitting there. A little shaking cup of water, trying to take a pill.
Well, I'm trying to fill in because his voice didn't show up. I brought the next worst hands. I didn't even know about it.
Voss's hands are stiff and they get straight when he tries to be poignant, and he's just a dummy with clay.
I had no idea. Nobody told me. I was told Virginia Beach. So I'm sitting at the table. So I go to Selfish Keith. I go, you know, Bobby's thing. You're going to pop by and visit? Because Bobby, when I spoke to him on the phone, I said, Keith might stop by. Said, yeah. You know what, man? Yeah, I'm going to go. Like it was a big favor. Who gives a damn, right? I'm going to go visit him. Like he has some erudite, you know, like you're suddenly getting a visit from George Washington Carver. I'm going to go. And so then Jim's sitting there with Corinne. And Jim goes, maybe I'll stop by too. I got to get my mail anyway. Literally, that's what he said.
That's exactly what I said.
Oh, great. Nice
friend.
So I go,
all right, cool. So I said, I understand. And then he was hanging out with Corinne. She was spending the night or whatever, a couple of hours with him. So he didn't want to give her up. And I said, on the steps of the Comedy Cellar, on the way to the club, I go, Jim, are you trying to, you know, find a way to get her not to go because we're going to see our friend?
Well,
no,
I
wanted to go.
And did you say that?
I don't remember. I don't care if she goes. Why would I
mind
if she goes?
I don't remember. Well, yes.
Yes,
no,
you
do remember. Carl Rove, shut up.
No, she was just hanging at the Comedy Cellar. That was all she was doing.
Oh!
That's comedy.
That explains it.
Yeah.
Oh, she does comedy at the Cellar?
No, not at the Cellar.
Okay. No, I was just wondering. So she was hanging at the Cellar and she came along as one of our crew. They are regulars.
Listen, these stupid.
No, I'm just asking a question.
The only reason you even told me about it is because you wanted a ride. Fucking creep. It wasn't genuine.
No, I didn't want to ride after the night before. Don't ever fucking sneeze in my car. I'm fucking pig. I'm a weirdo.
I'm not a weirdo. You sneeze.
You made an uncomfortable situation.
Oh, you afraid if you put your thin hands up, your sneeze would blow them off? Fucking skeleton fingers.
At least I admit everything I did. You're still
you
lying.
You didn't admit it. You act like you turned your head and were courteous. You did. You tilted it to the right 3 degrees.
You know what? When you leave to L.A., I'm going to swoop in on this fucking job. Obviously, I've been zeroing in on it all
week. Yeah. He's been showing he can show up early.
Yeah, I show up early. I don't show up with a distracted sunglass and a distracted, busy face like I'm a goddamn nuclear scientist.
You show up only because you had to plug a gig. You don't care about the guys. You only care about Caroline's.
All right, listen. I care about the
guy. Shut up, because last week Opie invited me, and then you re-invited
me. He was being
me.
Polite. What, what was he supposed to say? Don't come back?
You're very irritable. I don't want you taking that medication ever again.
See the collection of people that keep calling this show because Opie invites them. Oh, my God.
Oh, fucking Opie's amazing, no matter who it is. Hi, how are you? Yeah, come on in. All right, I was just asking for a quarter, mister. Who are you?
They all look at me hoping.
Ben comes in.
You're paranoid, Opie.
A stack of papers with, like, these Xerox pictures on him. Looks like mugshots going, did you talk to this guy? It's like a police questioning.
Opie,
what, did you talk to him? Did you invite this man down on June 19th? You said to him, yes, come down. You can be on the show.
Opie wants to be
nice.
Loved.
No, not at all.
He's not trying to be nice.
I just
feel.
I don't like the confrontation when I'm not in the studio.
But the confrontation won't start.
So these people come over to me and they're hoping to come on the show.
They're not asking you, can I come on the show?
They're not asking you.
And if they don't ask, you don't have to say, come on down.
Yeah. All you have to do, if you really know how to work the world, you do.
I don't know.
On these producers, XM, these guys are scumbags. They're really fucking going tough. They want us to get names on. And then when I show up, everybody understands. Name. When Bob calls in, they don't understand.
We really have to take a break.
Yes,
we got a professional newsman checking in next.
Well, oh, he's going to give us a little news on the shuttle launch.
Scott Walterman from XM News.
Yes.
On the way. And
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down those curtains.
Got to say hi to Hoagie real fast before break. Hoagie!
Hey, what's up?
From whackbag.com. What's up, Hoagie?
Not much. I'm down at Club Risque right now. Ooh. The Opie and Anthony van has arrived, and indeed there is an Opie and Anthony van.
Ah, they haven't painted over it.
Well, it looks like they might have rushed to put the wrap back on it.
Yeah, we don't know where the WoW motorcycle ride is, because they haven't checked in a while.
I heard from them. I believe they're on around exit 8A on the turnpike right now.
Okay.
So they're about an hour away from Club Risque, and they're on their way.
All right, very good. Thank you, Hoagie.
Hey, no problem.
Actually, we got Jim, who's part of the convoy, I guess.
All right.
Jim in Jersey. Go ahead, Jim.
Yeah, you got it, Colin. That's exactly where we are. We just passed 8A, just passed the car truck merge.
Colin.
We had a couple
nice.
Of people that pulled into the rest area, and the rest of us were rolling down the turnpike.
What'd you pull into, Jim? The phone's crapping out.
They pulled into the turnpike, Jimmy.
All right, more motorcycles joining the ride?
Yeah, we've had a few join along.
Okay.
Not many, but we've had a few join along. We're doing good. We basically got everybody together.
Okay.
Which is a nice thing to do, is actually keep everybody together for a change.
That is a nice thing.
When you do a large run like this, you end up having people split up.
Right.
But actually, I think I just lost the whole crew.
All right, Jim, thank you.
I don't know if they pulled over. All right, later,
guys. Good luck to you. They're going to be at Club Risque later on this morning. Want to take a quick call from Scott Walterman?
Yeah.
Ooh. Scott.
Yeah.
You're live on the Opie and Anthony program.
Hey, what's up?
Here he is, Scott Walterman. Are we broadcasting the shuttle launch today on XM?
Yeah, we're going to carry it on channel 133. We're going to go on the air about 3:30 Eastern. The launch is scheduled for 3:51 Eastern, 12:51 Pacific. So we'll do about 20 minutes leading up to the launch, listen to the launch, and stay with the vehicle till it gets to orbit.
Now, let me ask you a question, because a lot of people, a friend of mine was telling me that the launch, what they're looking at is possible thunderstorms. Now, is there going to be some kind of a thing because there was at one point a weather issue, or is there not, like, anything in that kind of a works?
Yeah, there's an issue with the weather. They got to have a 20-mile clear around the radius of the Cape. The skies have to be clear, no thunderstorms, because in case something goes wrong, and they got to bring the shuttle back and land here at the Kennedy Space Center.
Is this thing taking off today, Scott? Got a percentage?
I'd give it an 85%.
85%. Now, we had a little mishap this morning with the window cover coming off.
Yeah, that was kind of weird.
Yeah. Is that making people nervous down there at the Cape? Kind of as a omen thing?
You think after 2 years we'd have stronger glue.
You know, it's kind of a weird deal. When it first happened, you know, I was like, oh, my God. Because especially since, you know, the problem with the Columbia was
tile
falling down on the tiles. Yeah.
Yeah, people are saying this could be a problem.
But what happened was there's windows on the shuttle. You know, they got the windshield, and then there's these two windows right above the command capsule inside the vehicle.
Yep.
And when it's sitting on the pad, they have covers on the actual glass, on the windows. One of them fell off. dropped about 60 feet and damaged two heat tiles.
Yeah.
Now, the heat tiles are glued to these panels, which are removable. So they pulled the panel off. They have a spare. They put the spare back on. And they say, not a problem. They're good to go.
Well, that area isn't really that critical either. As far as piles
that go. That area around Cape Canaveral, and this is not to be racist, is not safe. I had tinted panel windows, and a couple of, let's say, Latinos came along, and then I left it for 20 minutes, and they were gone too, so they might have something to do with their own that.
Are you saying that perhaps somebody stole or was trying to steal these panels on the
Well, show? I'm saying I know the area in Florida. There's a lot of Vatos Locos, as we like to call them, and they're known to remove panels in a matter of seconds.
Scott, are you familiar with Colin Quinn?
No.
A comedian, Colin Quinn?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. He was on MTV on that game show.
Wow. Thanks, Scott. Oh, that was weird. That's exactly who he is and exactly how you should say it. Thanks, Scott. MTV, that was my last gig.
Remote control.
Yeah. No. That talking game show.
I want to know a little bit. Scott, what do you do with XM? You're a news guy?
Yeah.
We don't have an XM news station, though, do we?
No, but we do a lot of stuff on the air like this.
So you kind of run around from channel to channel whenever a story pops up and kind of chime in? Because I know we have CNN and Fox. What do you do at XM?
Yeah, that's a good question.
I was trying to figure this out. I was like, yeah, we got this news guy. He's going to be talking about the shuttle thing. It's like, what is he doing? The shuttle isn't launching.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep that question from being answered.
That's good,
from being asked, you know.
Right,
I mean?
From being asked, because they might say, what does this guy
do? Have you done any reports on the shark attack, Scott?
Right.
What was your last story that you covered?
For XM?
Yeah.
We did Live 8.
Oh, Live 8. Okay. That's not really a story, though.
Who was the guy that was crying? That wasn't him, was it?
No, that was Bruce Kelly.
Did you hear that one, Scott?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You're right
that
over
crying? That crying guy from The Who?
Did you hear Bruce crying?
Yeah, that was on our channel.
Yeah,
I know.
Wonderful.
It really sounded tasteful, especially after the bombing last week, that he was crying because they didn't play anything off Live at Leeds.
Is this going to be your first live shuttle launch there, Scott?
No, I've been here many times. Before I came to XM, I was at NBC and CBS and ABC and all the
others. And are you like a science reporter? Or?
No, just general assignments.
General, but you happen to be there for other shuttle launches, just coincidentally you were covering it for another channel?
Yeah.
Oh. It's usually left to the science or tech guys.
It's pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, I've seen one from about 50 miles out at night, and it was pretty intense. Yeah,
we're about 3 miles from the pad. And when that thing takes off, you know, the first thing you see is the engine's light.
Yeah.
And then you actually, like, get kicked in the chest, like somebody, like, took the flat hand and pounded you in the chest.
Again, that might be some of the sound people Colin was speaking about.
Then the ground starts to shake. You hear the rumble. It's pretty impressive.
And that's from 3 miles away.
Oh, yeah.
So if you're 2 or 1 mile, it's got to be even more.
Yeah. It's funny because NASA sent out an email this morning. They said, don't turn your car alarms on because the shuttle will set them off.
That's terrific.
That is funny.
What's the closest you could get?
This is it.
3 miles.
Well, as a civilian.
Yeah, I hear you.
I mean, I assume NASA's got people closer, but
I'd say the astronauts are a little closer.
Yeah.
They're right in that thing.
So they're really thinking it's going to happen today, right?
Yeah, I would say, you know, they're given, I think, the last weather projection is their main concern right now is 60 that they'll launch. But if I had to bet on it, I'd bet on launch today.
Well, no shit.
Yeah.
All right,
Scott, thank you so much.
All right.
Scott Walterman, have fun, enjoy the show, and hopefully it will be safe.
You should videotape people that are 2 miles away getting blown back by it. That would be cool.
Well, it's going to be on XM 133 starting at what time?
About 3:30.
At 3:30.
Now, Scott, exactly what happens as this thing starts to take off? Like, exactly what is going on when they count down and what is the mood and stuff like that?
I think people are pretty...
You know, we are going to make no friends
at XM.
None whatsoever at XM. If you keep hanging up on people in mid-sentence.
Hey, that was a group effort.
Yeah.
Just because Jimmy sets it up doesn't mean you got to hit it.
I didn't set it up. I was genuinely interested.
Oh.
Like you all didn't look at me going click.
Everyone did.
Yes.
Let's say hi to Tony in Philly before we take a break. Tony?
Yeah.
Tone?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I'm about to do an assault on the media, Channel 10. They have a show called 10, and it's live from the Lowe's Hotel, and I'm just going to go right up behind them in the back window and put some signs up for you guys.
Okay.
In Philly?
In Philly?
I just want to give you guys a heads up. It's only a Philly thing. I'm taping it. So I'll send a copy of the tape to Ben.
Yeah, we have the Assault on the Media contest happening right now, and still Buffalo Paul is in the lead. He did a great one in Buffalo.
And if you're sending it and you want Ben to open it, send it in a little baggie that's tied at the top.
Nice.
Can we believe...
I'll give you guys a heads up so anyone in Philly can turn on the TV and...
All right, good luck to you. The best Assault on the Media for the month of July went to MiFi and A Day in the Studio with us.
I saw three good ones yesterday for you guys. One was, Is Street Fairs Poison You?
Oh, yeah.
And the other one was Notes on Malls for Women. Find out if you're in danger.
Yep.
And then I forget the third one.
I heard the one with the street fair.
Street fair food. Is it poisoning you?
Yeah, we had that one yesterday.
Street fairs, they're fun. But is there a hidden danger?
How about the black dude that in the Howard Beach case that him and his friend the other day, they couldn't stop themselves. They robbed a Puerto Rican dude on the train.
Yep. Grabbed a chain, the sneakers, gun
Yo,
point.
Yo, run that chain.
Yeah, that was great.
He's out of the lawsuit.
Oh, absolutely. I don't think he's getting any
Sharp
cash.
It's like, you're out of the law.
You know, the lawyers will try to keep it out. Wow, that was after, you know.
He's traumatized.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Yo, run the chain.
He was striking back.
Oh, you know, the effects
Isn't
of racism
funny, though?
Like
are
that
long.
Fucking Cutler in the Black Rage defense.
Yeah. Stop it. Guilty.
We should regroup.
Should have all had a bat over the head.
We've all run out of energy. We got
not me, Ope. I'm peppered
up.
What?
We got Chris Angel coming in studio.
Ooh. Who's Chris Angel?
He's like a rock and roll magician. He's like the real deal. I guess he's going to do something cool for us today at 10 a.m.
Oh, is he going to make Bob's stomach disappear?
As we go to break, Anthony.
Yeah.
Bob Kelly crying.
Is this live?
Yes, we're live. Bruce, where were you, buddy?
I was right up under these hogs.
Bruce Kelly is a complete tool.
I was all right. I'm sorry. I'm absolutely crying. I can't help it. I really can't. This is no fake. The whole moment just kind of got to me.
Fucking cry, baby.
It was just very... I mean, you know, it's just the Who. I can't help but be a 14-year-old kid out there with the Who. And that's it.
You can't cry. Don't cry in a satellite radio.
Sorry.
Oh.
This is very awkward. I'm sorry, but I'm sorry.
As a man, that is so tough to listen to.
Ooh, I can't help but be a 14-year-old kid out there with the news. That's it. Sorry.
Fucking cry, baby.
I'd be crying if I had to watch The Who, too, but for different reasons.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Sorry. I'm sorry.
Because you're a faggot, all right?